Vista snowy Lambeau Field, the home of the Green Bay Packers, as today the Packers with a 2-8 record play host to the Minnesota Vikings, who come in here with a 6-4 record. Hi, everybody. I'm Gary Bender, and alongside me, a man who's in Pro Football's Hall of Fame, number 19, Johnny Unitas. And, John, the Minnesota Vikings can ill afford to stumble today.
Now with a 6-4 record, and Chicago, of course, was 6-5. Minnesota so far a half a game ahead. If they lose this one, it'll be all tied up, Gary.
Well, I tell you, both these teams coming in here with new faces at quarterback. 2 weeks ago, Tarkenton and Dickey went out with broken legs. So we have David Whitehurst and Bob Lee with the starting calls.
Two brand new ones, and everyone watched David Whitehurst play an outstanding ball game against the Washington Redskins. But Bobby Lee has yet to throw his first pass against the Green Bay Packers.
I don't know, John, how quarterbacks like this weather today, but we're going to have about 6 inches of snow before the afternoon is over. The temperature kickoff time, 26 degrees, as the Minnesota Vikings have had it pretty much their way. They've won 5 in a row. Let's go to the field now as we're ready to go. A kickoff just about ready to take place. Kicking off will be the Minnesota Vikings. They'll be kicking off from left to right as you see Fred Cox, number 14. Cox, who announced that he'll be retiring after the 1977 season. Back deep is Steve Odom for the Packers, and he's standing on a goal line you can barely see. As you can see, they have the heat coils on here. It is melting some of the snow, but it's starting to snow just a little bit harder as we approach this kickoff time. These two teams have been in many snow affairs. Many people recall 1966 when the Packers and Browns in a title game, very similar weather conditions. It's short, and Eric Torkelson's got it for the Packers, and he brings it back out. Let's make that Steve Wagner, and Wagner is dumped in a hurry by the white shirt Minnesota Vikings. So as we spot the ball for you, and that is going to be a problem throughout the course of the day, the ball is going to be close to the 40-yard line. The Packers will have Whitehurst at quarterback. The running back's going to be Will Harrell. He started in place of Nate Simpson, who pulled that hamstring Monday night, and also Barty Smith. The ball marked on the 37-yard line. Here's Barty Smith, and Smith gets some running room. Jeff Wright, number 23, over to make the stop. Barty Smith, who now has set a personal rushing high for him in a season. He needed only 2 yards coming into this game, picking up some pretty good yardage.
Let's watch it, Gary, as Barty Smith takes a handoff, moves back to the outside, some good blocking up front. Jeff Wright, number 23, in on a tackle. If he got by Jeff Wright, he picked up another 10, 15 yards.
A gain of 5 on the play. It'll be 2nd and 5. And boy, the conditions are going to be difficult today. The footing, for example. Whitehurst gives off to Barty Smith. There's a flag on the play as Barty Smith may have gotten a yard, and that's all. Interesting enough, John, both these teams have had a tough time stopping the rushing games.
It certainly has. As last week, we saw that the Peyton ran 275 yards against the Minnesota Vikings. The Vikings given up 383 yards total offense against the Chicago Bears last week as the Chicago Bears defeated them. And both teams have been able to run the football. Most teams have been able to run the football at Minnesota and Green Bay as well.
Don Wedge, our referee now, going over to the far side to spot this particular penalty that's coming up. This telecast is presented by an authority of the National Football League. It is intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express written consent of the Green Bay Packers and the National Football League is prohibited.
Offsides, defense, number 75. It's 3rd down.
Offside against the Minnesota Vikings. So it's going to bring up 2nd down and about a yard to go as we spot it from the far side of the field. They're less than a yard to go. Odom and also Ollie Smith flanked to the bottom of the screen. Whitehurst giving off to Will Harrell. He's in trouble, and Harrell is not going to get that first down. In fact, he lost a yard. Carl Eller, number 81, flying over. Boy, Eller this year has been playing well. He has 10 sacks coming into this game, 35 years old. He just seems to get better with age, and it's going to bring up 3rd down and 2 for the Packers. I tell you, John, when you're a quarterback in weather like this, that first pass has got to be tough to come up with, right?
Well, you want to watch what you're throwing this kind of weather, Gary. It looks like it's fairly windy out there, and it's also difficult for the receivers to hold on if you're really zing the ball to them.
Andre Thompson has come in, 3 wide receivers in the game on a 3rd and 2. Whitehurst with his first pass of the game, and Barty Smith, the intended receiver, but Carl Eller got out there. Carl Eller made two fine defensive plays back-to-back, and the Packers are going to have to get rid of the football. Coming in will be David Beverly. He comes in here fourth in the NFC in punting with a 40.9 average. As you can see, the Vikings trying to stay warm on the far side of the field. Expected 6 inches of snow before this game is over. Beverly goes back, and he's going to be kicking from his own 31-yard line. Manfred Moore, number 36, is back. He was acquired this year from the Oakland Raiders. He's been a fine returner since they acquired him.
Last time the Vikings had a punt back was in 1968 against the Washington Redskins when Charlie West went 98 yards.
At the 20-yard line, Manfred Moore, and he draws the crowd as he's short of the 30-yard line. Good coverage that time by the Packers. Eric Torkelson, the first to get down there, and the Minnesota Vikings now have the football for the first time. 13-21 now left to go in this first quarter. Looking ahead now to the CBS Sports Spectacular, I'm going to be journeying to a warmer climate next week in Las Vegas to bring you the International Record Makers Tournament of Weightlifting. A dozen world record weightlifters going to be there. Vasily Alexiev from Russia, Bruce Wilhelm from the United States, next Saturday at 5 on the CBS Sports Spectacular. First down, Bob Lee gets off to Chuck Foreman, and Foreman, as there's a flag on the play, comes across the 30 to the 31-yard line. Bob Barber, second-year man from Grambling, number 70, made the tackle. Barber, according to Bart Starr, has been one of the real pleasant surprises this year for Green Bay. The penalty against the Vikings. In a day like today, John, the footing is tough. Is injury more prevalent in a game like this?
Well, not really, Gary. The thing that's really tough is your defensive backs must play off of your receivers down there because the offense has a little bit of an advantage when if you're going to start throwing the football. Because of the slippery turf, and they have to be able to spade off a little bit.
Offense, only 6 men on the line. First down and 15.
Well, you have to have 7 men on the line.
Well, it's a little difficult to see right down there, but the offensive men must look at that nose of that football to stay on the ball.
First down, 15 yards after that step off. Ball at the 26-yard line. Foreman again, and flags everywhere. Both teams kind of on rocky footing here as we start this game. We've got another penalty against Minnesota. Vikings being penalized for the second consecutive play, and field position on a day like today really becomes paramount.
And I think the snow may favor the Green Bay Packers. The Foreman, who's very, very quick, was not able to move that time.
False start, offense, number 68, first down.
That's Charles Goodrum, the left side offensive guard for the Vikings, who left on that false start, so two penalties back to back, and it makes it first and 20 now. Ball is on the 18-yard line. Bob Lee to Brett McClanahan, and Dave Purifoy was through there. Also Bob Barber, but Purifoy, who they feel can be as good as anybody in the league, with the quickness in for the loss on the play. Let's look at some of the footing, John, and how difficult it's going to be.
It's going to be tough for the offense and defense both. As you notice, these fellas try to step and move with the ball. A fine tackle by Purifoy right there. He really knocked the ball loose, but the ball was blown dead. Barb Barber also in on the play.
So now it comes to a second down and about 21 yards to go. A loss of one to the 17-yard line. Bob Lee, his first pass. Wide open, far side, the completion, and only a 2-yard pickup on the play. Reaction to Brett McClanahan, who caught the ball, but excellent coverage that time by the Packers. Brett McClanahan this year now has caught 27 passes. That's going to bring up third down. Still long yardage to go. The ball marked at the 21-yard line, third and 17.
Here, as we mentioned, Bobby Lee, who has never thrown a pass against the Packers, completed his first try, so he's batting 1,000% so far. He's been in the league 9 years, has played against the Packers, but mainly as a punt kicker, as a kicker.
Last week against Chicago, he had to throw in some real bad conditions. A windy game against the Bears. Back to throw Lee again. Lee on third and 17, and he's going to go down. That is the 31st sack of the year for the Green Bay Packers, and Dave Purifoy got him. That's his eighth of the year. And so now it brings up fourth down. The ball clear back to the 15-yard line. Coming in to kick will be Neil Clabo as we have 11:45 to go, first quarter of play, and this is a big game for the Minnesota Vikings. They have a half-game lead on the Bears. The Bears winning impressively on Turkey Day, awaiting the outcome of this one. Harrell is back deep along with Johnny Gray, and now Gray moves up, and Harrell's by his lonesome. That's kicking the ball to be Claybo. He's at about the 2-yard line. Good snap. And a fine kick by Claybo. Will Harrell is backpedaling. He's going to take the ball at his own 40 and backpedals and is dropped immediately. Coming down was Nate Allen. So good coverage that time by the Vikings. The Packers with the football. 11:14 to go first quarter. There's no score at Lambeau Field.
Now let me tell you something. I've eaten the dust of many a rodeo, and I build up some kind of a thirst. That's why I drink light beer from Miller. It has a third less calories than the regular beer, and it tastes real good. Light says giddy up to all that flavor, and woe to being filled up. And that ain't no book.
What? Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less. You don't have to lose sleep worrying about that drive to work tomorrow. Not when you've got Firestone Snowbiters going with you. To dig you out and pull you through, they've got two sets of deep biting teeth. And in between, traction bars for quiet running and long mileage. In radials, bias, or retreads, they'll put deep in your winter driving. Firestone Town and Country Snowbiters. Pleasant dreams.
I tell you, the fans here, the natives of Green Bay, they kind of thrive on this weather, John. They just seem to react well to it, and they know how to dress for it. All right, the Packers, after that 43-yard kick, have the ball on their own 42-yard line. Dennis Havig has started at guard, number 62, in place of Steve Knutson, Con Carr, Dick Himes, the tackles, Mel Jackson, one of the guards, and Larry McCarron, the center. The tight end is Rich McGeorge. First down for the Packers. Play action by Whitehurst. He's got a lot of time to throw the ball. It's to Barty Smith. And Smith fighting for the first down. He's got it. Barty Smith gets the first down. Jeff Seaman, the middle linebacker, reacting on the play. Barty Smith, the leading receiver for Green Bay.
Excellent protection afforded David Whitehurst as we watch the offensive line doing the job on a big purple people eater gang there. The Minnesota Vikings going back into a double zone, left Barty Smith open. Whitehurst looking all the way, took Barty Smith, picked up the first down. Excellent protection, Gary, and that's what he's going to have if he's going to do anything against the Minnesota Vikings.
Barty Smith came in here with 31 catches. He was 10th in the NFC, and now Eric Torkelson has checked into the backfield with Barty Smith. First down, 11:06 to go, first quarter. The ball at the 47-yard line of Green Bay. Whitehurst gives off to Eric Torkelson, and Torkelson fighting for yardage. Torkelson picks up 7 yards on the play. He's been hurt a lot, but getting some playing time today. Jeff Wright, the strong safety, coming up to make the stop for Minnesota.
And we'll take a look at this play coming up. As you see, Whitehurst on the handoff to Torkelson, moving back in. Fine hold given by Mark Concar and Dennis Havig on some fine blocking up front. Enables Torkelson to pick up some fine yardage. Jeff Wright, number 23, in on the tackle.
They're going to mark it second down 4. A pickup of 6 on that play by Eric Torkelson. Torkelson had the best rushing day of the year for the Packers, 73 yards. This is Barty Smith. Little or nothing on that play. Good reaction that time by Minnesota's Doug Sutherland. He's the biggest man in that forward wall. And, John, that's something about the Vikings this year. They're not as big as they've been in the past. Page is playing at about 230. Marshall maybe at the same weight.
Well, Minnesota has always relied on the quickness, especially Alan Page. Most people always felt that if you're going to do anything against the Vikings, you had to run at Alan Page. He would always catch everything from behind with his great quicknesses, which they all have. Everyone has been able to run against Minnesota so far this year, and it looks like Green Bay is taking a page out of their book and trying the same thing.
Well, you can see the footwear, a real problem today. Third down and 4 for the Packers. From their own 41-yard line, Whitehurst back to throw. It's over the middle, intended for McGeorge, but down the field further, Ollie Smith had a better crack at the ball. So it brings up fourth down for the Packers, and Beverly will come in once again. A field position battle. Boy, I tell you, John, in a game like today, a mistake can be very, very big.
Well, it's tough. If you're throwing the football and one of your offensive men happen to fall down, especially the receiver, and you hang the ball up there for him, defensive man must play off the offensive man because he can afford to make a mistake back there as well. It could be an interception.
Madfrin Moore is back for this kick now from Beverly. Beverly's done a fine job kicking, but today it's going to be difficult to keep that average up. Fourth and 4, he boots away. He's angling to the near sideline. And Manfred Moore fakes the fair catch, and it goes into the end zone. Boy, what a play-acting job that time by Manfred Moore. He acted like it was coming right to him, and it may have held up the pursuit down the field. It goes into the end zone for the touchback at the 20-yard line. A 42-yard kick. No score. The 9:30 mark of quarter number one.
Ford introduces the new Futura. A dramatic combination of styling and technology for 1978 and beyond. Futura. Its striking design is the result of computer modeling and extensive aerodynamic testing. Its excellent fuel economy results in part from the use of high-strength, low-alloy metals in Futura's construction. And Futura's ride is the result of a newly created advanced front suspension system. Futura. In a world where cars are looking more and more alike, it represents a change. A dramatic combination of styling and technology from 1978 and beyond. Realistically priced for today. See your Ford dealer for a personal test drive.
Well, it looks like Christmas time here in Green Bay. Look at them bundled up here. Hardy fans in Lambeau Field. First down at the 20-yard line now for Minnesota. No score. 9:30 to go. First quarter. Bob Lee, the quarterback. He gives off to Brent McClanahan. McClanahan's got some running room. He fumbled the ball. It's loose at the 21, and Green Bay has it. The Packers have come up with it. Bob Barber, number 70, comes up with a fumble recovery. And, John, that's the big break we talked about in a game like today.
And that's a big, been a big, real big problem for the Minnesota Vikings so far this year, is their 24th fumble and the 18th one that they've lost. Jim Carter, number 50, makes a fine tackle right there. Bob Barber is well in on the play. Green Bay has the ball, and it's the first break of the ball game, the first turnover of this ball game.
And the ball is at the 21-yard line of Minnesota. The Packers, who have lost five in a row to Minnesota, eight of the last 10. They can play the spoiler role today. Harrell and Smith, the running backs. Play action by Whitehurst. Whitehurst, near side to Harrell, and Harrell is bombed out of bounds in a hurry by Fred McNeil. Good coverage at time by McNeil. He's a fourth-year man out of UCLA. He, along with Matt Blair, two fine young outside linebackers.
Oh, this play deserves another look. Let's watch the protection afforded Whitehurst. He comes back, fakes a running play, and then looks over and just drops it over the top of the linebacker's head.
Harrell had a 49-yard catch Monday night against the Washington Redskins. That time he picked up a yard. It's going to be second and nine. The ball on the 20-yard line. A break now for the Packers. Are trying to capitalize on it on the fumble by Brent McClanahan. Whitehurst, he gives on a delay to Harrell. And Harrell's got some running room, and he's got the first down. Will Harrell fighting his way up the field and showing that he can run in these adverse weather conditions. Eventually tackled by Jeff Seaman.
Jeff Seaman made a fine play that time with just a little draw play coming up the middle by Harrell. As you notice, some fine blocking up front. Harrell picking his spots. Dennis Hadvig on an outstanding block as we watch Harrell keep his legs moving. Good leg drive by Harrell to pick up the first down.
Will Harrell, third-year man from Pacific. He's been a very versatile performer for this football team, and it's a first down. The ball is on the 11-yard line. Whitehurst giving off to Barty Smith, and Smith straight ahead, and the Packers doing a pretty good job of blocking up front. That time, Barty Smith moving inside the 10-yard line. It's going to bring up second down. The ball is going to be marked at the 7. Boy, very difficult to see. I'll tell you, the officials have a tough time today, John, trying to place that football.
Well, Barty Smith so far has been the club leader with 353 yards rushing, Gary. And he was just 2 short yards of his career high, 355 last year. I'm sure he's already surpassed that.
He did on the first carry this afternoon. Second down now, 7. They can get a first and goal at the 1-yard line. The ball at the 8. Here's Barty Smith again. Barty Smith won't go down. Drags tacklers with him. Barty Smith inside the 5. Let's look from the end zone now and see what kind of blocking Barty Smith got.
All right, here we go. Let's watch Alan Page right here as they kind of double-team him and move him out of the hole. Barty Smith picks a hole very good. Paul Krause now in on the tackle. 22, also Alan Page on the tackle.
All right, now here's the situation. The ball's on the 3-yard line. It's third and two. They can get a first and goal at the one. Third down, 2 yards to go. The ball at the 3-yard line. We have Whitehurst rolling out. He's got a block. Touchdown. David Whitehurst, who can run extremely well, got a big block from Barty Smith, and the Packers have taken a 6-0 lead at the 7-18 mark of the first quarter.
Let's take a look at it here. Smith, number 33, on an outstanding block, and Whitehurst just kind of cruises into the end zone to take a 6-0 lead over the Vikings.
If there's one thing that really impresses Bart Smith is the running ability of number 17. He can run with the best of them.
Darian Furman, he threw for 3,000 and some yards in his 4 years career and ran for 1,523 yards, I believe. So he's an excellent runner along with a good being a very good passer.
All right, point after 10. Chester Markle will boot it, and holding will be Beverly. 3-yard run by David Whitehurst. Whitehurst getting the big block. And, John, in a game like this, you wouldn't expect a lot of scoring. We're going to have a delay of game now against Green Bay. They're going to back up. That should not affect Chester all that much. What I started to say in a weather conditions like today, you want to score early before they deteriorate even more.
I don't know whether it's going to deteriorate or not. I'll tell you, it's coming down here. I feel like singing Jingle Bells right
Would
now.
Would you do it, please?
Jingle Bells.
All right, Markle to attempt it now after the delay.
Put 5 seconds back. Hold up.
Wait a minute, he says. Oh, you can hear that. I've never seen that happen before. Have you, John?
No, I never have. But I tell you what. You can hear that official. He didn't need a microphone either.
Don Wedge says, wait a minute. Let's listen.
5 seconds. 5 seconds.
Now, what does that mean? Does he mean there's 5 seconds left before they get another delay of game or what?
I don't know what. I didn't want to wait 5 seconds for some reason or other.
All right, we're going to try it again. Boy, what a struggle this is to kick this one. The snap, the kick by Chester Markle is good. And the Packers have taken, no, wait a minute, it is not. It was wide to the left. It looked like it was through, but it was not. It just grazed the upright on the left-hand side, and that could be a big point after. It's 6-0. Green Bay at 7-18.
Mr. Highbloom?
Huh?
Mr. Highbloom.
Yes?
Yeah. We understand that you're taking a trip with us tomorrow.
Trip?
Yeah, well, we want you to know that Avis is working right now.
Avis?
It's vacuuming your car, checking the oil, brakes, even the air in the spare tire.
Spare tire.
One of the ways Avis tries harder is working at night, so you're ready
harder?
In the morning.
Yeah.
Oh, by the way, it's a Chrysler Cordoba, and it's blue. See you in the morning.
See you in the morning.
We try harder, Avis. Avis, we don't know another way.
The Quintrix two-color picture tube from Panasonic brings you a very lifelike picture. Because Quintrix tube is our inline picture tube with an extra pre-focus lens that concentrates and focuses the electron beam to bring you Panasonic's sharpest picture ever. So lifelike, you may even feel you're part of the picture. Quintrix 2, one more reason Panasonic is just slightly ahead of our time.
A scientist with superhuman strength. The all-new adventure, the return of the Incredible Hulk. Monday at 8, 7 Central and Mountain.
Well, point after touchdowns are important, John. Look how close this was by Chester Markle.
Well, they just hooked that ball a little bit, Gary, and bounced back to the outside.
You know, I thought it had hit the inside and went in, but it was hitting the outside and going out. And in a game like today, with it 6-0, Chester's now going to be ready to kick off. Manfred Moore is back deep. Interestingly enough, the Packers, with a lot of problems moving the football, they had rushed for an average of 92 yards a game. That's the lowest for the Packers since 1934, but today they're moving the ball. They've gotten 12 yards out of Smith, 8 out of Harrell. And let's watch now as Chester Markle kicks right off into our camera. He hit a funny one. Got it picked up by Nate Allen. And all kinds of problems. He's knocked out of bounds. The ball is at the 35, possibly the 40-yard line. And, John, the kickoffs, everything is difficult today because of the weather conditions. That's Sammy White, by the way, that came up with the ball.
First down.
The runners look like they have ice skates on. They're just sliding around wherever they possibly can. The footing is very, very treacherous down there, and they have to make sure of what they're doing.
They're going to mark the ball at the 32-yard line. Now, Bob Tucker, number 38, you see him, the tight end, to the near side, acquired from the New York Giants. Here's a give to Chuck Foreman, and Foreman fighting his way forward. Speaking of Bob Tucker, the Giants are having a difficult afternoon, John. Cincinnati's leading them 27-0. That's in the second quarter of play. Also, some other scores. Pittsburgh leading the Jets 20-13, second quarter. And Atlanta, with that great defense of theirs, leading Tampa Bay 10-0. You just don't score very many points on the Falcons. 6-0 here. Green Bay with the lead. Second down, 8 for Minnesota. You see Bob Tucker to the top of the screen, flanked out. Give to Foreman again. And did the ball get loose? I believe it did. The ball is loose. They're unfiling to see who's got it. The Packers are indicating they have it, but no, the Vikings have recovered their own fumble.
You know, Gary, they've been running Foreman, but Foreman really has always been well defensed against Green Bay. His career statistics are as follows. In 9 ball games, he has had 161 attempts, gained 610 yards for a 3.8 yard average, and only has managed 67 yards per game.
He's only had one 100 yard day against them, and he's had 13 in his career. Third down now, still 8 yards to go for Minnesota. Bob Lee possibly going to have to throw the ball. He gives on a delay to Foreman. Foreman hit by Dave Roller.
Foreman on the draw.
Dave Roller, excellent reaction. We have an
Roller
made
the tackle.
74. Let's look at it.
Fourth down.
Dave Roller has been a great asset to the Packers since coming from the Canadian League a couple years ago. Look at Foreman, handle the boys in front of him, and then make the tackle on Foreman. Dave Roller, number 74, made the tackle.
So it's going to bring up fourth down, and now Claypool will kick. The Packers are going to send back Will Harrell. Harrell has the longest punt return this year in the National Football Conference. He returned one 75 yards against the Saints. 5:19, here's the snap. Claypool gets off a very, very high kick. And Will Harrell is going to have to call for the fair catch, and he fumbles it, but he's on it, and he paid for that one. Hit in a hurry by Matt Blair. So the Packers have the football. They have a 6-0 lead with 5:10 to go as it continues to snow here at Lambeau Field.
This fresh egg is going to help us sell this brand new Freeflex shoe from Freeman. Watch. You can do it with any new Freeman Freeflex. Let's use the same egg.
This realistic 40-channel CB radio is on sale right now at your nearby Radio Shack for the unbelievable low price of $49.95. That's 50% off our catalog price. And our realistic model 466 is ready to use on all 40 CB channels. For under $50, get the convenience and security of two-way CB communication today. The sale-priced, realistic 40-channel CB radio. Only at Radio Shack, a Tandy company.
You don't think it isn't snowing here in Green Bay? I think it's snowing even harder, if that's possible. Hello there. All right, first down for the Packers at the 29-yard line. The Packers with a 6-0 lead. 5:10 to go, first quarter of play. Whitehurst giving off to Will Harrell. Harrell hitting off the right-hand side, and he's got some running room. Alan Page made the stop, and the Packers are moving the ball very effectively on the ground against Minnesota.
Let's take a look at Harrell as he takes the ball from Whitehurst, goes off the right tackle. Some excellent blocking up there by Barty Smith, Dick Himes, Rich McGeorge, opening up the hole and picking up some good yardage. They're running the ball very well this afternoon, Gary.
Gain of 8 on the play. It'll be 2nd and 2. The Packers, since the first game this year, have not scored more than one touchdown in a game, and they'd like to do something about that today. Whitehurst giving off to Harrell again, and Harrell fighting for the first down. He's very close. Will Harrell off the right-hand side got a block from Dennis Havig, and it's a first down, Green Bay. Packers getting that field position back into where they want it. The big turnover in this game, a fumble at the 21-yard line by McClanahan, Packers in five plays, scoring on a three-yard run by Dave Whitehurst. They have heat coils underneath the field here, John, but I think the snow's coming down so hard and so fast that it's hard to have any effect on the playing field right now. First down. That's the fourth first down now for the Packers. And up the middle they come, trying to continue that move. That was Barty Smith, the workhorse fullback, and Alan Page again making the stop. Page has lost a lot of weight, and one reason, John, is he's gone into a jogging program.
I thought he would do enough jogging on that football field without doing it after practice. He's an outstanding tackle, always has been for his whole career, and really an outstanding man as well.
You know, if those people don't move around, they're going to get snowed in. Second down now, seven, a gain of three. Whiters to throw on second down. Eller after him, and I mean after it. Carl Eller drops him for a loss, and that's 11 sacks this year for number 81. Carl Eller, boy, what a performer he has been through the years. He is a five-time All-Pro.
Excuse me, take a look at Dick Himes blocking on Carl Eller. As you see Eller get to the outside right here, David Whitehurst should have stayed back inside behind Himes. No reason to go back outside that tackle where Himes was blocking Eller. So Himes has the right to expect Whitehurst to stay back in that pocket, back to behind him rather than go outside that end.
Say, that's the way to keep your toes warm, huh? David Beverly there trying to get ready if he has to kick. Ollie Smith, Steve Odom, and Andre Thompson have come in. Three wide receivers on a third and 14. Back to throw, Whitehurst again. A loss of six on that last play. Throwing and intended for Thompson, but a little tall for him at the 50-yard line. So it's going to ring up a fourth down, and Beverly will come in and kick. There's Thompson out of East Texas State.
He was wide open on that play. The ball was just a little high. Don't know whether Thompson could have gotten off the ground to go up and get it or not, but it was a little high, and most receivers don't like to go up for that ball, Gary. If it's high or not, they know there's someone lurking there who's going to give him a shot.
Manfred Moore, who just doesn't like to fair catch a ball. In fact, he's only done it twice, is back now for the Vikings. Beverly to kick. And I'll tell you, it's snowing even harder right now, if you can believe that. Fourth and 14 now. And he gets off a very fine kick. Moore going back. He's got it, he's on 25-yard line and slips and goes around and buried. He is buried at that point. I'd say it's hard to hold up on a playing field like this when somebody goes down.
That was a fine 41-yard kick by David Beverly. Tim Maresco in on the tackle.
Hey, John, this Wednesday night, CBS invites you to share one last Christmas with Bing Crosby as it presents a warm Yuletide special with Bing, his family, and guest stars, recorded in England shortly before Bing's untimely death. That's Wednesday at 9, 8 Central and Mountain, right here on CBS. First down now. The ball is at the 30-yard line of Minnesota, 6-0, Green Bay. Bob Lee to Chuck Foreman. Foreman stays on his feet. Foreman dropped by Jim Carter. You know, a question comes up on a run like that, John. Here's Foreman with all those moves, but he's got to give up some of those, doesn't he, on a field like today?
The field is very tricky down there. Watch Foreman as he comes through the hole. You notice how he's running fairly flat-footed so that he can't make those real sharp cuts as you see him sliding and slipping in there. Jim Carter, number 50, in on that tackle.
Gain on that play of seven. It'll be second down, a long three to go. Give to Foreman. He's got the first down and then some. He breaks outside. Johnny Gray's got him. Rams him out of bounds. But Chuck Foreman now starting to make his presence felt. Got quite a block from Brent McClanahan. Number 44. What a player.
Take a look at Foreman working on the Green Bay left side of defensive line. Brent McClanahan, number 33, makes an outstanding block as Foreman goes back to the outside. Number 28 for the Johnny Gray, number 24, making the tackle for the Packers.
Gray, according to Bart Starr, is quite a performer. He really likes him. What a heart that kid has, he said. First down.
Bart says that defensive secondary is brightest picture out there.
The 49-yard line, the ball in the Minnesota end of the field. This is McClanahan. McClanahan now finding some running room. He comes into Packer territory. M.C. McCoy, who's vastly improved. Second-year man from Colorado. Boy, it's kind of miserable down there on that sideline. John, you were saying you're all right if you're playing, but when you stand around on that sideline.
Oh, the sideline's the worst place to be, and what's really bad is when you go in at halftime and get all nice and toasty, warm, and everything, have to come back out and face this 10-degree weather. You just shiver and shake.
You told me you played up here one time Christmas time, though it was 73 degrees.
That's right. No one believes me, though.
All right. Gain of 3, second down, 7. Bob Tucker again in a slot or wing position to the near side. Foreman again. Got a block. Chuck Foreman now slipping and sliding. He's going to bring up a third down for the Minnesota Vikings. He got a block, turned outside, but all of a sudden the Packers, particularly Bob Barber, got over there. Third down, still a long 3 to go. Let's make it 4 as we go inside. 1 minute to go here in this first quarter. Some scores. Pittsburgh leading the Jets 20-13. I bet you this one's in the snow. Los Angeles leading Cleveland 9-0. It's got to be snowing there.
Being right on the edge of that lake, it has to be. No other way.
And New England leading Philadelphia 14-0. Third down. A long 3 to go. Sammy White goes in motion. Bob Lee off to McClanahan on the screen. He cuts back beautifully. And he's got, I believe, a first down. Fine run there by McClanahan. Bob Barber eventually caught him. First down, Minnesota.
Well, they had him back in the backfield, Gary, but this slippery turf really enabled McClanahan to break back and pick up the first down. Let's watch it as you see the Green Bay Packers coming in. Jim Carter, it looked like he had a pair of skis on there. McClanahan making a very fine move, enough to pick up the first down. It'll be first and 10 with the Minnesota Vikings, and that's the end of the first quarter.
That's the end of the first quarter with a score. The Green Bay Packers, 6. The Minnesota Vikings, nothing.
The Bell system recognizes that many seemingly unrelated business problems are really communications problems in disguise. So we've provided our account representatives with the skills and equipment they need to take a company's problems and our solutions to them and fit them together into a total communications system. For we firmly believe that in solving problems for companies like yours, the system is the solution.
A guy I know tells me this new Sunbeam adjustable groomer razor is the greatest shaver ever made. Well, I say, so what? I'm a blade man. He says, try it and you won't be. He's right.
Here's how Sunbeam's new groomer razor works. 12 stainless steel blades cut at 8,000 strokes a minute through the thinnest shaving head you can get. Stands whiskers up and shears them off, at or below the skin line.
You a blade guy? Try this. It may be the last time you use a blade.
I was asked to talk about the incredible Black & Decker Workmate. There's almost nothing it can't hold. But the Workmate is so incredible, I'm gonna let it do the talking.
The Workmate from Black & Decker and nobody else. When America has a job to do, it reaches for Black & Decker.
Along with John Unitas, this is Gary Bender. We enter quarter number 2 in snowy Lambeau Field. 6-0, Green Bay on top. Chuck Foreman, number 44, keeping those hands dry. That's got to be a problem. Bud Grant, geez, wearing a jacket today. He's tough. This weather doesn't bother him at all.
Got two things, a jacket and a hat.
All right, first down now for Minnesota. They have it at the 40-yard line of Green Bay. Bob Lee, play action. Got a lot of time. Drawing down here, wide open, Sammy White, touchdown. Sammy White got wide open, and there was no contest on that one. A 40-yard touchdown strike from Bob Lee to Sammy White, and it's all tied up 6-all.
Let's take a look at it. You see Bobby Lee coming back after a fake to the fullback, standing backer with excellent protection. Spots Sammy White all alone behind Mike McCoy. As you see, Sammy White going into the end zone, an outstanding receiver.
He is quite a receiver. You know, that's his 6th touchdown catch of the year. He had 31 catches coming in here. Now, the point after, we mentioned earlier how important it is. The Packers missed theirs. 14-53, the first play of the second quarter. Kick by Fred Cox is on the way, and he got it. And the Minnesota Vikings now have taken a 7-6 lead. Just inside, 15 minutes to go in the second quarter play. The Vikings with a must game here today.
10 years ago, no one knew me. I was part of the famous no-name defense. Then we built our reputation by being fast. Now, I don't want to lose that. I drink light beer from Miller because it doesn't fill me up, has a third less calories than a regular beer, and it tastes great. Now, everyone knows me.
Hey, I know you. You're,
Nick Bonacani.
No, that's not it.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less.
When you're looking for tires that put teeth in winter driving, drop in on the Snowbiters at Firestone. Look at them. Two sets of deep, biting teeth that really gobble up snow. But they don't take a bite out of you. Right now, a polyester cord Snowbiter is just $20 plus federal excise tax. And you can charge them. For quiet running, long mileage, and plenty of traction, Firestone Town and Country Snowbiters.
I think that kind of tells the story here, John. You know, nobody seems to be that unhappy. Bart Starr, slowly but surely, trying to rebuild this Packer team.
I haven't heard anyone speak against him yet in this whole town.
All right, Fred Cox to kick off, 7-6, and he hit one a little weird, picked up short by the Packers, being brought out now by Darryl Goforth, who is a backup center, and Goforth getting good field position for Green Bay. A 40-yard touchdown strike from Bob Lee, who's 3 of 3 now in the passing department for 50 yards. A 40-yard strike and the point after giving the Vikings the one-point lead. So the ball is going to be marked outside the 40-yard line. Well, let's see. They're going to say the 38-yard line, 2 yards short of the 40-yard stripe. The Packers, who have been moving the ball pretty well on the ground, led by Harrell's 18 yards, Marty Smith's 15. They come out now to the bottom of the screen. Odom flanked out. Ollie Smith to the top. David Wider's going to throw on first down. A screen complete to Rich McGeorge. McGeorge stays on his feet and fights for 3 yards as Fred McNeil is over there. You can see how treacherous the footing is as McGeorge is kind of slipping and sliding that time after he caught the pass. That's his 14th catch of the year. John, in working with you throughout the course of this season, you've always pointed out the importance of the tight end.
Tight end does a big job blocking for your running attack and opening up the passing game as well. If there's anything that McGeorge doesn't have, he certainly has fine hands and runs good patterns. He does not have the speed you would like for the tight end to have.
Gain of 4, 2nd and 6. Whiters off to Harrell. He fumbled the ball. It's loose. Who's got it? I believe Minnesota's got it. They do. The Vikings have come up with it. So the turnovers are now even. Earlier, Minnesota fumbled, and now it's Green Bay.
Let's watch the handoff and see what happens. He does not get his arm all the way up, and David Whitehurst hit Harrell on the elbow. Jeff Simon on the tackle and recovery.
So it's going to put the ball in good field position at the 42-yard line. Jeff Seaman, the guy from Stanford, he's been playing with injury this year, but he's a fine middle linebacker. Rashad to the bottom of the screen, flanked out. First down at the 42 of Green Bay. 7-6 Minnesota. Give to McClanahan. McClanahan to the outside, and look at him fight for yardage. Brent McClanahan, who earlier fumbled, setting up the only Packer touchdown, hanging on with both arms that time.
Let's take a look at McClanahan. Looked like he left a little early that time as he gets back to the outside. Ed White doing an outstanding job blocking for them. Very good block by Ed White.
Gain of 5, well, not quite that. Let's make it a gain of 4. Second down, 6 yards to go. 13 and a half minutes to go before halftime. Lee gives off to Foreman. Look at him flip and slide. He tried to change direction, and look at him fight for the yardage. He's got a first down. Chuck Foreman looked like nothing doing on that play, but he would not go down and drag tacklers with him. So Chuck Foreman, after a slow start in this game now, is starting to really run effectively on this treacherous turf. First down, Minnesota. The Vikings this year have had a tough time scoring. They're well behind past performances. They've averaged 14.7, and if they continue at their present pace, that'd be a low for them. Right now, they have 7 points on the board. They have a first down. Give to Foreman again, and Foreman the big hole. Chuck Foreman got beautiful blocking behind Ed White and Ron Yeary. From the end zone, you'll see how number 73 and 62 block for him.
Let's watch Ed White block on Butler as he knocks him back to the outside. see the hole that Foreman picks back up inside. Good blocking by the offensive lineman, Dave Purefoy, in on the tackle.
Second down, five now. Ball at the 26-yard line. Rashad again to the bottom of the screen, flanked out. And Bob Tucker goes to a wing position to the top of the screen. Bob Lee giving up McClanahan. And McClanahan is inside the 20 and his forward progress close to the 15-yard line. First down, Minnesota. Tom Toner and Willie Buchanan over there. And right now, Minnesota running behind the right side of that offensive line.
The offensive line, Ron Yeary, Ed White doing some fine blocking.
Defensively for the Packers, they have Mike Butler, Dave Roller, Dave Purefoy, and Bob Barber up front, a young but a very fast improving forward wall. Chuck Foreman now has come out of the ball game. Sammy Johnson, number 48, has replaced him. He's back there with McClanahan. First down. The ball at the 16-yard line. This is Sammy Johnson, the former San Francisco 49er. And Sammy Johnson rips off 7 or 8 yards. Minnesota not doing anything fancy, John. They're just coming right at him.
No, in this kind of field, you may as well use that single wing, and that's what they're doing. Yeary and Ed White doing some good blocking. McClanahan doing some good utility blocking, trying to clean up on a linebacker as they break through the hole.
They've made a change. The Packers have up front. Mike Butler, the number one draft choice from Kansas, comes out. And Clarence Williams, who last week didn't play, ending 107 straight games that he'd been in, is in there. He's number 83. He's been a starter many years for the Packers. Second down now. And again, it's the big fullback fighting for yardage. And did he get the first and goal? Sammy Johnson spinning and fighting. He got it. It's going to be a first and goal now for Minnesota.
Take a look at some good blocking by the offensive line of the Vikings. Very good down block there. Sammy Johnson just kind of picking his hole, moving around. Carter, number 50, making the tackle. It's tough footing out there. The defense and offense both have to be wary of where they're placing their foot and trying to maintain their balance.
It's first and goal now at the 5-yard line for Minnesota. Bob Lee to Johnson again. Sammy Johnson gets to the 3. Pickup of 2. Tom Toner played in place of Gary Weaver, who went out with a knee injury. Toner from Idaho State. He was a 6th-round draft choice in 1973. So with 10.5 minutes to go in this first half, the Vikings with a 7-6 lead and trying to build on it. Minnesota has been tough on Green Bay. Of course, when you win as many division titles as they have, you've got to beat the teams in your division, and they've done it 8 of the last 10 years against Green Bay. Foreman, McClanahan, now the running backs. Second and goal at the 3. Chuck Foreman. Boy, there's nothing on that play. Great reaction by the green-shirted Packer. Willie Buchanan came flying up from that left cornerback spot. He was first to get there. Then Fred Carr. Great support that time, and it's 3rd and goal, and they gained nothing. It's still at the 3-yard line.
You can see the bad footing down there on that play. Foreman just ran up one of his offensive tackles back, Ron Yeary, and it was no hole. Willie Buchanan came in to stuff the whole play.
Chuck Foreman comes out now. Sammy Johnson checks in for him. 3rd down goal at the 3. Lee giving off to McClanahan. He's not going to get it. The fired up defense of Green Bay is equal to the occasion. They tried a little scissor action in the backfield.
The hole was there, but it was built very, very quickly. Let's take a look at the plays. You see Bobby Lee spinning around and handing it off. Look at the action. Mike McCoy and Willie Buchanan both up there to stop that play.
So it's 4th and goal, now at about the 2.5-yard line. So the field goal attempt is coming up. Fred Cox, who's had a tough time this year, he's hit 5 of 12. Playing in his 206th consecutive game, 38 years old. The snap, the kick by Cox is on the way, and Fred Cox hit it. So the Minnesota Vikings have taken a 10-6 lead with 8:42 to go before our halftime. Minnesota trying to win game number 7.
The best-selling American-made small car versus Japan's bestsellers.
Hello, I'm Jackie Stewart at Indianapolis, where the best-selling Japanese cars competed head-to-head against the best-selling small car made in America, Ford Pinto. In 2 driving tests certified by the United States Auto Club, which car performed best? Let's find out. and the truck passing test, a 78 Ford Pinto moved out and passed, quicker than a Datsun B210. Passed quicker than Toyota Corolla. Passed quicker than Honda Civic. In the highway entrance test, which car accelerated to the highway speed first? Pinto. Faster than Datsun. Faster than Toyota. Faster than Honda. And 78 Pintos now have added features and are sticker priced lower than last year. Check out the complete line of Ford Pintos yourself at your local Ford dealers. Another better idea from Ford.
Everybody is dead.
Robert Redford. Everyone he trusts will try to kill him in 3 days of the Condor on the CBS Sunday Night Movies at 9, 8 Central and Mountain.
Just a moment ago, Fred Cox with a 21-yard field goal now has moved in second place in the all-time scoring list, trailing only George Blanda as he surpasses the output of Lou Groza. He has 1,350 points. Congratulations to Fred Cox with that field goal. 10-6. Short kick. Bring it out across the 20 to the 30-yard line. Bringing that ball out is Terdell Middleton, their number three draft pick out of Memphis State. And so now the Packers trailing 10-6, but John, their defense holding there at the goal line. I'm sure it has to give their offense a little bit of a lift.
Well, you got to play both offensively and defensively. And now it's up to this offense to move the ball against the Minnesota Vikings. They've been able to do it the first part of the ball game. Let's see if they can't do it the second part here.
The ball at the 28-yard line. First down, Green Bay. Torkelson and Barty Smith, the running backs. David Whitehurst, first-year man from Furman. He gives off to Eric Torkelson, and Torkelson protects the ball and spins for some yards. Torkelson's a good man in this situation. He'll hang on to that football. I tell you, your whole game plan's got to change on weather like today, John. You just got to remap everything.
Well, Torkelson and Barty Smith both are the type of runners that are plotters. They're not very quick and not very fast, and they just take the ball and just kind of plot like the old single wing type backs. And these are the type of people you're going to have here today as long as they can maintain control of the football.
Gain of three, second and seven for the Packers. Ollie Smith to the bottom of the screen, also Steve Odom. Whitehurst wants to throw on a second and seven. He's got Odom wide open, and it's deflected. That pass would have been completed, except Matt Blair stepped back, and Matt Blair has been a big play man all year long. He's blocked four kicks and has one interception. Stopped a big pickup on that play. You could see Odom getting open on it.
Odom was wide open coming in the seam, and the ball was just a little late getting there. Matt Blair making an outstanding play on it.
Third down now, seven. Torkelson coming out of the lineup. The Packers took the lead early in this game, 6-0 on a three-yard run by Whitehurst, but now falling behind 10-6. Three wide receivers, Thompson, Smith, and Odom in. Marty Smith, the only running back. On 3rd and 7. Whitehurst. Far side, Odom. Boy, he was covered well that time by McNeil, and also coming up, Bobby Bryant. 4th down. The Packers will have to kick again, and that play was as well covered as you can. John, you've said many times that one mistake a young quarterback will make is they'll try to force the ball into some coverage.
Force the ball and also look at the receiver that he's going to all the way from the line of scrimmage. It's a difficult thing not to do. It's something that he has to learn and be picked up through experience, through everyday repetition as he reads the coverage and tries to go to the open man. And we know that Dave Whitehurst has not played, but it's a second ball game. He's practiced and he's an outstanding young man, and Bart Starr is certainly enthused about this young fellow.
On a 4th and 7, Beverly to kick from the 20-yard line. Manfred Moore is back, and Beverly's doing an excellent job of kicking the ball. Manfred Moore's all the way back to his own 20-yard line. Look at this. That's one of those I dare you type situations, and they got it.
I won't get you anything but put in a hospital trying to jump over top of someone.
What a coverage that time by the Packers. They bury him, and Minnesota has the ball at 7:35.
Now at Sears, there's a color TV on sale you really have to touch to believe. Now save $80 on Sears Sensor Touch TV. Just $399.95 for a 19-inch picture, an electronic tuner with no moving parts to wear out, a solid-state chassis, and Sensor Touch. You've just seen the touch of a finger change channels instantly. But even when you see it, you have to touch it to believe it.
I believe.
Sensor Touch, on sale now at Sears.
International Falls, Minnesota. A car sits on a frozen lake.
through January, February, and March. Then, in April, it started. Thanks to a diehard. The diehard, sold only at Sears.
Hey, the grounds crew here has their work cut out for them today. They're just continually trying to keep the playing field in some kind of working order. That last kick, by the way, of Beverly's was 49 yards. And you just don't expect that kind of kicking on these kind of weather conditions.
So far, that's been Green Bay's best offense, with the exception of that first drive that they had for a touchdown.
At the 25-yard line, the Vikings with the ball. Foreman, McClanahan, their running backs. They lead 10-6. A give to McClanahan, and no place to go. It's Dave Roller. Look at Roller. You know, Roller's one of those guys that talks to the opposing team all the time. He and Fran Tarkenton, I understand, used to have quite a conversation. He said he was looking forward to introducing himself to Bob Lee. Well, McClanahan has met him now.
Well, he hasn't had the opportunity to get to Bob Lee yet, but he has met McClanahan. Let's take a look at, see what McClanahan sees as Dave Roller comes bursting through the line. Good play by Dave Roller.
Second down, 14. A loss of four on that play. The ball at the 21-yard line. This is Foreman. Foreman, big running room, and he's close to the first down. Chuck Foreman eventually hit by Carter and Buchanan, but that's the same spot that they've been so effective, off the right-hand side. They're opening up some holes.
It's hard to say whose responsibility that is over Gary, whether they're having a safety force or a halfback force. If it's a halfback force, Buchanan is not coming up quick enough. If it's safety, it'd be Johnny Gray. And they're working on that left defensive side of the Green Bay Packers, particularly the outside of the line.
That was a 12-yard pickup on the play. Third down now and a yard to go. Bob Lee to Foreman, and he's hit from behind the line of scrimmage by guess who? Great reaction by 74. Dave Roller, boy, what a game he's playing here in this first half of play. Foreman, by the way, has 51 yards in these weather conditions.
Footing doesn't seem to bother Dave Roller. There's McClanahan and that Dave Roller met each other, or Foreman rather. McClanahan leading the block, but missed Roller. Roller making a good tackle.
They're going to measure, John. I didn't think they had the first down, but they're going to bring the sticks on to be sure.
I thought Roller had Foreman back in the backfield.
He struggled forward, and so as an end result, they got to bring the chain gang out. Boy, I tell you, it's tough to measure. They didn't get it. You can see Dave Roller doing a little officiating himself out there. Roller indicating how far they missed it, and that's like a fish story. He had his arms a little wider than the official. So it's fourth down, and Minnesota's going to have to kick the football. 6:18 to go in this first half. Minnesota with a 10-6 lead now. We said they're going to kick the football. Maybe they're not going to. They've got a fourth down and less than a yard to go, and they're indicating they're going to go for it, I believe. You can hear the crowd in the background. Now they're bringing on the kicking team. I wondered about that one, John.
I thought maybe they're going to stall and take a five-yard penalty, hope to draw somebody offsides on a long count.
They thought about it for a while, so they are going to pump the football on fourth down. But for a moment, it looked like they might go for it. Johnny Gray is back deep now for the green and gold. Neil Clabo, there he is. He's standing where there's some snow shoveled away, but not very much. There's Gray, drying his hands. Clabo hits a line drive. Johnny Gray's got a chance. And look at the pressure put on by Minnesota. Excellent coverage on that play. Coming down in a hurry was Scott Studwell, the rookie from Illinois. Looking ahead now to next Saturday, the Mixed Team Golf Championship. The final two rounds of the Mixed Team Championship will be televised from Largo, Florida, and I'll guarantee you it won't snow down there. Teams are going to be comprised of one member of the PGA Tour and one member of the Ladies Professional Golf Association Tour.
We have Arnold Palmer, Sandra Palmer, and the Carol Mann and Lee Trevino, and that's the tall and the short of things there, Gary.
Next Saturday and Sunday at 4 Eastern Time, a Mixed Team Golf Championship. First down, Whitehurst giving off to Barty Smith, and he's hammered. Excellent reaction that time. May have picked up a yard, and that's all. Matt Blair reacting on the play. So at the 5:42 mark, the Packers, after moving the ball effectively in the first quarter, have been stymied since that time.
The big rusher in this game has been Foreman, 11 carries, 51 yards. Harrell still the leading ball carrier for Green Bay, 18 yards on five. Second down, a gain of one, second and nine from the 33-yard line. Whiter gives off to Torkelson, and what a collision they have at the line of scrimmage. Staying on his feet and getting maybe a yard is Carl Eller, helmet to helmet that time with Torkelson. Let's watch 81 collide with Eric Torkelson. There's Blair, 59.
Barty Smith, number 33 as well. He's taking a look at Matt Blair right here, but Barty Smith misses the block on Carl Eller.
That's Jackson, Mel Jackson.
Jackson on, of course, Blair, and knocked Blair back into the hole.
It was Eller that made the stop, but you can see Blair coming right up and meeting that block of Jackson, second-year man from USC. Third down, seventh. Whiters rolling out. Barty Smith, the intended receiver. He was blanketed in a hurry coming over there. Excellent coverage, Matt Blair, and also Jeff Wright, the strong safety. Matt Blair's all over the place.
Matt Blair playing a great ball game this afternoon, making a lot of tackles, back in there knocking some passes down. One particular one on Odom when we thought we had a reception down there.
Jim Palmer, statistician, who's a busy man today, has Whitehurst 3 of 9 for 14 yards thus far. So Lee, on the other hand, has hit all three of his passes for Minnesota, and one of them a big one, a 40-yard touchdown pass. Hey, there's Alan Page. Now, what is this? Look at Alan Page. He's on the backer side of the line, getting the towel out of the way, so they had to stop play. Well, I guess when it snows, you have some crazy things happen, huh? Beverly getting ready to kick now. He's going back. He's wiping off his shoes. You can see him on the left side of your screen. Manfred Moore back for the Vikings. Beverly gets it underway. Manfred Moore is going to let it hit. And that ball is going to go to about the 30-yard line. Green Bay down there. Moore does one. Cincinnati now leads the Giants 27-6. Pittsburgh still leading the New York Jets 20-13. Foreman and McClanahan, the running backs from the 30. This is Foreman. And he's hit by big Mike Butler. And I mean big. He's 6'5". They list him at 265. And that might be on the light side.
That's where they've been working most afternoon, on Butler with Ron Yeary blocking. Of course, Ed White blocking on Dave Roller. Roller has made some good plays, but most of the time they're going at back at Butler, either going inside of him or outside.
Second down now, six, a gain of four by Foreman. Foreman now with 55 yards. His best this year, 133 against Cincinnati. Bob Lee off to McClanahan, and number 75, Dave Purifoy, nose to nose with him on that play. Dave Purifoy is so quick that he's always been plagued with a lot of injury problems. You think they aren't cold?
I don't see them play those instruments. Those things are probably frozen by now, Gary, with all the snow and the moisture and everything else that's out there.
You think you can get even a noise out of those right now? Third down, four for Minnesota at their own 36. Bob Lee to Foreman. There he goes. First down. He fumbled the ball. It's first. He's got it. Minnesota has recovered their own fumble. Chuck Foreman, after that big burst off the side, had the first down. And Sammy White, I believe, comes up with a fumble recovery.
Flanahan makes a key block, knocking linebacker to the outside, opening a hole up for Foreman. You see the tackle. You see the ball loose. Sammy White in on the play, number 85.
He disappeared, didn't he, after he got on that ball, but he comes up with a very opportune fumble recovery. And it's now first down, Minnesota. We come to 2.5 minutes to go in this first half. Sammy Johnson, Brent McClanahan, now the running backs. Bob Tucker, you see him split to the top of the screen. In motion goes McClanahan. This is Sammy Johnson. And Johnson off the right-hand side. Boy, you talk about tendencies today. They've just hammered that right side, their right. Green Bay's left side. Dave Purifoy making the tackle, cutting the legs out from under him.
Well, they have Ed White and Ron Yeary, who are two of their best blocking guard and tackle on the rookie out there. and they're doing an outstanding job. Green Bay is not getting enough force from their either their linebacker or their defensive secondary, and that is one of the positions that Bart Starr feels that he has a good group of men in, and that is the secondary.
Closer you shave, boys.
The more you will need.
The more you will need.
Great balls of comfort.
Great balls of comfort.
To do it with ease.
Great balls of comfort.
Oh, just like Noxzema.
Noxzema. Great balls of comfort to you.
The closer you shave, the more you need soothing, medicated Noxzema.
Great balls of comfort to you.
Woo. Hi. Ever need to rent a car fast? Watch. Hertz, number one club, number 21586, arriving in San Diego at 2 p.m. on RAL Flight 9. Returning it there tomorrow. Okay, thank you. It's all ears to it.
When you're in the number one club, nobody makes renting a car faster or easier than the superstar. Even before you get there, your car is pre-assigned, your forms filled out. So rent a Ford fast from Hertz, the superstar in rent-a-car.
It continues to snow here in Lambeau Field. The forecast prior to kickoff is 6 inches before it's all over, and it's going to reach that, I believe. Two-minute warning just being executed here. The Minnesota Vikings with a 10-6 lead. The big play in this game has been a 40-yard touchdown pass from Bob Lee to Sammy White. The other story has been the running of Chuck Foreman, 66 yards and 13 carries. The Packers scored first, but the Vikings now have come back to take this four-point lead. The ball at the 48-yard line. Bob Lee on a 2nd and 6. No place to go. Now he dumps it off to Bob Tucker, and Tucker falls forward what appears to be the first down. Steve Luke, the strong safety, making the tackle.
Bob Lee, with plenty of time to throw the football, looks downfield, looking for Sammy White. No one is open. Goes back to an auxiliary man. Bob Tucker, formerly New York Giants. Steve Luke, number 46, making the tack.
You've always been impressed with Bob Tucker, John. He's a good runner, isn't he, when he gets the ball?
He's an outstanding runner, and one thing that he has that Stu Voigt doesn't have, and that's from good speed, Gary. He's able to get deep on most of your safeties.
First down now. The ball at the 42 of Green Bay. A minute 40 to go. First half lead. Back to throw. Pressure put on by Bob Barber. It's complete. Ahmad Rashad, he is dropped immediately at the 30-yard line. That will be another first down for Minnesota. Jim Carter got him down.
Let's watch. We see the protection again, and this is the answer to a good thrower, a good passer. The ball thrown to Ahmad Rashad. Rashad is the only wide receiver in the top 15 of either conference, and pass receiving was not caught a touchdown pass. Jim Carter, number 50, making the tackle.
That's Rashad's 35th grab of the year. He had 53 catches last year. Timeout on the field at 1:32. Looking ahead now to the world's strongest man. The ninth event, Mr. Unitas, is coming up. This is the refrigerator race, which the competitors with 400-pound refrigerators strapped to their backs race 40 yards.
I like last week's better where they were lifting the girls, Gary.
All right. Well, anyway, next Saturday, right here on CBS, the CBS Sports Spectacular, 5 o'clock Eastern Time. The refrigerator race on the world's strongest men. Well, Bob Lee is really having some game today, John. He's 5 of 5 now for 68 yards on that last pass completion to Rashad.
Well, this is, you know, we mentioned before the ball game that he has played NFL for 9 years and has never thrown a pass against the Packers. And so far, as you mentioned, he's 5 for 5, so he's not doing too shabbily.
All right, Minnesota used their first timeout. They have two remaining with 1:32 to go in this first half of play. The ball is just about on top of the 30-yard line. Minnesota with a 10-6 lead. You see the time in the right-hand corner of your screen. The Vikings doing a good job of throwing the ball. A 40-yard touchdown pass, Lee, 5 of 5. He gives off to Foreman. Foreman already with 66 yards. And Chuck Foreman goes for 5, maybe 6. Jim Carter making the stop. Chuck Foreman's having a big day here, and you might expect him not to have under these weather conditions. 2nd down, 5. There's an old argument that's always brought up, John. Who has the advantage, the offense or the defense, in playing conditions like today?
Well, I feel that the offense, especially if you're going to throw the football, has the advantage, because defensive men have to play off was to be concerned about not slipping or falling down and giving the offense an easy touchdown.
Second and five, Lee, intended for Robert Miller. And that is the first pass of the afternoon that he has not completed. Robert Miller, a fine receiver, he has 22 catches. Third-year man from Kansas, could not come up with it. And there's your time, 56 seconds, and it's third down five. Minnesota not afraid to throw that football, but it's been set up by the running of Foreman with 71 yards already. He's on his way to his third consecutive 1,000-yard year. Ezra Johnson, 78, checks in, replacing Mike Barber at defensive right end for Green Bay. Bob Barber. Third and five. Give to Foreman. Foreman's got the first down. And Foreman's to the 15-yard line. Johnny Gray dropped him. Time being very important in this game. And Minnesota now has used their second timeout.
Let's watch as they continually run the right side behind Ron Yeri and Ed White. Good blocking, good hole, and fine running by Foreman as he picks up the first down.
We have a change now. Clarence Williams replaces Butler as they continue to attack that side of the Green Bay defense.
Looks to me like they're going to have to change their defensive strategy against the Vikings. They continue to run that right side. They'll run them right out of the ballpark so far. That is the only place that they've been successful, Gary. Of course, it's over there against the rookie.
49 seconds remaining. It's a first down for Minnesota at the 15-yard line.
Chuck Foreman now 15 carries for 80 yards.
Well, Chuck Foreman came in here with 768 yards, third in the NFC in rushing. Third also, actually tied for second in catches, but third in total yardage in receiving. And sixth in scoring. I don't know what else he could do.
He's been doing that since he got into the league, I'll tell you that.
All right, first down now, just outside the 15-yard line. Rashawn coming to the near side along with Sammy White. They're flanked out. Bob Lee, 5 of 6 in the passing department. Sammy Johnson, nothing. Boy, Tom Toner sealed that off, number 59. He came in and knifed in, and Johnson had no chance, no gain on the play. And now with 36 seconds, Minnesota running out of time. They have one timeout remaining, but they're not huddling. They're ready to go again.
Watch Toner on that play as he closes the hole.
You see the time ticking away. Lee to throw, Sammy White. White, Peter caught it, got out of bounds, and it gained maybe 3 or 4 yards. It's Buchanan, number 28, defending on the play.
I don't know if we have that on the screen, Gary, but you can see how far away the defensive secondary was on Sammy White. All Bobby Lee had to do was raise up and pop him, and they picked up some good yardage.
Sammy Johnson now comes in replacing Chuck Foreman at the running back department. 21 seconds. Minnesota has one timeout remaining. They want to save that for at least a field goal attempt. They have a 10-6 lead. Third down, Sammy Johnson fighting for the yardage. He's not going to get much. Going to bring up fourth down. The field goal team will come in as the time winding down. Minnesota now will use their third and final timeout to stop it, and they do. Well, wait a minute. They're going to run it down a little further. There it is, 5 seconds. So now Fred Cox, who's already booted a 21-yard field goal, number 14, comes trotting onto the field. He's already moved in second time all-time scoring, only behind another veteran, George Flanders. He announced his retirement this week. Fred will hang it up after the 77 season. What a season he's had, or career. He's 15 years with the Vikings. Five seconds left here in the first half. This is going to be now a 30-yard field goal attempt by Cox. Cox kick on the way, and Fred Cox got it. A 30-yard field goal by the venerable veteran. And now with 1 second left in this first half, it's 13-6 in favor of Minnesota. So Fred Cox, who's had a difficult 77 season, coming through here on this weather day that we've had. It just continues to snow. I just bet you the weatherman's going to revamp his forecast. It is not quitting like he thought it was going to. Let's look at that field goal again, John, and this is really going to be an interesting view of it by Cox.
If you can spot it through all this snow, we'll be very fortunate. The ball, as you see, goes up very, very quickly. Fred Cox puts it right through the middle for the 3 points. Minnesota 13, the Packers 6.
Looks like what?
1 second to go at halftime, Gary.
Looks like your chip shot. 13-6.
My chip shot never has gone straight.
I'm sure you don't play on these kind of weather conditions. So Fred Cox with two field goals of 21 and 30 yards. This will be the last play now, this first down. Going to try a little onside action. Jim Gaino, number 51, pounces on it, and that's going to end the first half. So the Minnesota Vikings with a must game here today, leading 13-6. They have a half game lead coming into this game. That's the end of the first half with the score. The Minnesota Vikings 13, the Green Bay Packers 6.
Мне нравится ваша рубашка.
He admires your shirt.
It's a cotton-rich fabric called Natural Blend. It's the Cotton Arrow by Arrow, 60% cotton, so it breathes.
Duchat.
It's got the extra comfort of extra cotton, plus durable press, no iron.
No iron. Natasha will do anything but iron my shirt.
If you're looking for comfort, look for the seal of cotton. The more cotton, the better you feel.
Well, you caught me doing a not-so-great job wrapping a great Christmas gift. A Kodak Tele-Instamatic 608 camera. It's almost like giving two cameras because it has two lenses.
Okay, star, do your stuff. Look how the telephoto lens can make the best part of your picture bigger. A Kodak Tele 608 camera doesn't cost a great deal of money.
But it gives a great deal of pleasure. And like all Kodak gifts, the Tele 608 camera says, open me first to save Christmas in pictures.
You're too good friends. Tonight is kind of special.
Hey, where you been? It wasn't easy getting tickets for this game.
Here, Bob.
Eddie, I know exactly what I want. I want the biggest steak you got and a bottle of Löwenbräu. Steak and Löwenbräu. Dolan, you're a genius.
When you want the taste of a truly great beer, tonight, let it be Löwenbräu.
Here's to the chef.
Mm-hmm. Here's to the bartender.
Archie's in for surprises. And you're in for some laughs when a secret vigilante group recruits him.
Would you join us in a little reprimand?
Hey, I'm with you all the way. I'll be a member of the club for life, Big.
Something special on All in the Family earlier this Sunday at 8, 7 Central and Mountain.
Next Saturday at 5 p.m. Eastern, CBS Sports Spectacular presents the International Record Makers Tournament of Weightlifting with the world and Olympic super heavyweight champion Vasily Alexeyev of the Soviet Union heading an international field of world record weightlifters. Plus the world's strongest men competition featuring the refrigerator race. That's next Saturday at 5 p.m. Eastern.
Not the only place today where it is snowing as hard as it is in Green Bay this afternoon is in Cincinnati, where the Giants are being clobbered by the Bengals. Let's get you up to date on all the scores right now. Weather is beautiful down in Tampa. 17-0, the Buccaneers about to lose for the 25th straight time. Los Angeles and Cleveland, tough game. Cold and snowy, and the Rams are ahead by 9 points. They scored a touchdown and missed an extra point in that game. Here's the Cincinnati-New York Giants score. 27-6, Bengals scored on their first offensive play of the game. When Anderson hit Brooks, they've been in command all the way. Philadelphia and New England, surprisingly no snow in Foxborough. Windy, 14-0 right now, and the Patriots lead the Philadelphia Eagles. Pittsburgh ahead of the New York Jets, and the Jets are playing very well. They had a touchdown call back off a blocked punt, or that game might have been tied right now. And of course, the game you're watching, Minnesota, Green Bay. Hard to see where the yard line markers are on that one, isn't it? 13-6 at the half. Vikings need it. Houston ahead of Kansas City. 14-3 is the score in that game. They are in the second quarter. Now, Chicago is off today because they played Detroit on Thanksgiving. Next Sunday, Walter Payton and all that gang go up against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Here's what the Buccaneers are doing this afternoon. Former Bear Gary Huff having trouble. Roland Lawrence steps up and intercepts that pass for the Falcons. And Haskell Standback got Atlanta on the board for the first time. Bartkowski has been throwing more this afternoon. Here he is going to Alfred Jenkins. at the 22-yard line, and that led to this. Stanbeck gets his second touchdown of the game, and Tampa Bay did not think that he'd gone in, but it was ruled a touchdown. Irv?
Ben, I was trying to take a peek at that Ram-Brown game. The Rams lead in the fourth quarter by a score of 9-0. I see backup quarterback David Mays. Dr. Mays is going out with an injury, but here's first quarter action. Pat Hayden, finding no one open, scrambles the ball, goes for a 23-yard gain down to the Cleveland 47-yard line, which sets up a scoring opportunity from the 7 for John Cappelletti. He goes in, touchdown. The extra point, by the way, was missed. Later in the second quarter, Rafael Septian kicks a field goal, and that's where it stands, 9-0. I don't know who the third quarterback for the Browns will be, but David Mays will be out the remainder of this game.
Irv, let's check in now on the Bengals and the Giants. We'll show you that first offensive play of the game for the Bengals, and Anderson, who's had an off and on year, really unloads this time. 48 yards, Brooks, it was 7-0 after the extra point. Archie Griffin, stopped by that tough Minnesota defense a few weeks ago. Longest run of the year was 25 yards until this 31-yard run right here. Booby Clark bounces off an umpire, careens past one man, and just battles his way into the end zone. Anderson wants Brooks again. Second time, these two hook up for a touchdown. It was 20-0, missed extra point. Anderson wants his rookie tight end, Jim Corbett, and he's got him, and it was 27-0 in this game before the Giants finally got on the board. Joe Pisarcik, coming off an injury, going to Robinson, number 85, and it was 27-6. That's the way it still stands, and they are now in the fourth quarter.
Brandon, a brief update on that Brown-Ram game. Terry Luck is the backup quarterback who will be playing the remainder of the game for the injured David Mays. But New England and Philadelphia are doing battle in the fourth quarter up there, and it's 14-0 in the fourth quarter. And here's a first quarter touchdown pass from Steve Grogan to Morgan Stanley, Stanley Morgan, and a 7-0 New England right off the bat. Grogan likes to go to the air, and this time he goes to his running back, Sam the Bam Cunningham, who takes a screen pass and wades down the left sideline, down to the Eagles 16-yard line, where Grogan puts the ball in the air again, this time hitting Darryl Stingley. Touchdown, New England. They led 14-0 here. The Eagles had an opportunity for a field goal, but passed it up here on a fourth down play late in the second quarter. Jaworski sacked, and that's the way things stand right now in the fourth quarter. New England 14, Philadelphia nothing.
All right, Irv, now let's check in on the Minnesota-Green Bay game that you folks are watching. Tough weather conditions out there, but Minnesota just about has to win this game. They can't stand a divisional loss with Chicago pursuing them. McClanahan turned it over right here, and that led to a Green Bay score. Harrell running on a bit of a draw. First down for the Packers. And how do you know where to spot the ball? Whitehurst on the keeper. The rookie from Furman gets in. It was 6-0. And then Lee, who has replaced the injured Fran Tarkenton, went to White. This is a beautiful pass play, considering all the circumstances in Green Bay. On any day, that'd be a nice play. Now, here's Fred Cox. Time running out. Hit this field goal. 13-6 right now. Minnesota leading Green Bay at the half. And, of course, coming up on January 2nd on CBS is the Cotton Bowl, matching Texas against Notre Dame with a national championship at stake. And Jimmy the Greek, what's your early line on that game?
Well, after watching Texas beat Texas A&M yesterday, I had it at close to even before that. But now you have to make Texas a slight favorite. Right?
Razor's edge in that game, Greek?
What do you get for a field goal?
3-5. The NFL Today on CBS will continue right after these messages from your local stations.
See Robert Redford and Faye Dunaway in the television premiere of 3 Days of the Condor, tonight at 9, 8 Central and Mountain on CBS.
The Philadelphia Eagles are probably the best 3-7 team pro football has seen in quite a while. On the year, they've actually scored more points than they've allowed, which are bittersweet statistics to coach Dick Vermeil. But Vermeil has a bright hope for the future. It's his young quarterback, Ron Jaworski, who has made his coach a firm promise, as told in the song, All My Tomorrows, as sung by Frank Sinatra.
Today I may not have a thing at all, except for just a dream or two. But I've got lots of plans for tomorrow.
and all my tomorrows belong to you. Right now it may not seem like spring at all. We're drifting and the laughs are few. But I've got rainbows planned for tomorrow, and all my tomorrows belong to you. No one knows better than I that luck keeps passing me by. That's fate. But with you there at my side, I'll soon be turning the tide. Just wait. As long as I've got arms that cling at all, it's you that I'll be clinging to. And all the dreams I dream, they go borrow on some bright tomorrow. They'll all come true, and all my bright tomorrows belong to
It continues to snow at Lambeau Field. The Minnesota Vikings lead the Green Bay Packers at halftime 13-6. In a moment, we'll be back with the start of the second half of play.
This realistic 40-channel CB radio is on sale right now at your nearby Radio Shack for the unbelievable low price of $49.95. That's 50% off our catalog price. And our realistic model 466 is ready to use on all 40 CB channels. For under $50, get the convenience and security of two-way CB communication today. The sale-priced, realistic 40-channel CB radio. Only at Radio Shack, a Tandy company.
America's best-selling new car in history. The new Ford Fairmont. What's behind Fairmont's success? Fairmont's mileage. Highest EPA mileage rating of any midsize car. Fairmont's roominess, more room for the money than any other car. Fairmont's price, lowest sticker price of any midsize car. Test drive America's best-selling new car ever at your Ford dealer, where the better ideas keep coming.
The Vikings have always been known as a rugged, winning football team. But then, you have to be pretty tough just to watch a game in Minnesota. Hi, I'm Doug Sutherland. I love the outdoors, so for me, Minnesota's a terrific place to live. They call this the land of 10,000 lakes. 10,000 mirrors that reflect more beauty than I could ever describe. Lakes that frame wilderness and dairyland. Lakes that show the Twin Cities. Lakes that move iron ore and grain all over America. Lakes for people to sail, ski, swim, and do just about anything you can do on water. The people of Minnesota are hardy, hardworking individuals. And many of them take time to help their neighbors through their United Way. They're volunteers in the Red Cross, Services for the Aging, YMCA, and many other agencies funded by our United Way. They love their football team, their communities, and their United Way. For all these volunteers, we'd like to say, thanks to you, it works for all of us, the United Way.
The preceding announcement was brought to you as a public service by the National Football League. 13-6 our score at halftime. Minnesota with the lead. And John, interestingly enough, in this first half, the Vikings have used a two tight end offense, Foreman 80 yards rushing, and they've run off that right-hand side.
Well, Tucker and Voigt are the two tight ends they've had in there. Both of them are excellent blockers. And the Vikings have been concentrating their attack, Gary, on that right side, and they've been working over Butler, and they've been working over Toner, and they have not been getting enough force either from the linebacker or the defensive secondary, and that's where they've been concentrating it. That's where they've been picking up the yardage.
John, on the other hand, you got to give credit to Bob Lee. He's hit 5 of 7 passes, one of them a 40-yard touchdown, and that's remarkable with the way the snow has been.
Well, with an offense, and you are, if you do throw the football, you do have the advantage because the defensive secondary has to play off of the offensive receivers. Certainly, the offensive receivers cannot make as sharp and as quick as cuts they would like to. Neither can the defense stay up close to them and try to protect against it. So their offense has been moving. Then Bobby Lee has been playing a good ball game, calling a fine ball game, throwing the ball when he has to, and Foreman, of course, has been picking up the yardage.
On the other hand, Fred Cox today, historic moment for him. He became second on the all-time scoring list, kicking two field goals, surpassing Lou Groza. Only George Bland is ahead of him.
You know, the funny thing about Cox, he was with Cleveland years ago when Lou Groza supplanted him when he was a rookie and sent him up to the Vikings.
Green Bay, on the other hand, John, started running the ball very, very well as they come out on the field, particularly in that first quarter. They scored on a three-yard run by Whitehurst, but then all of a sudden, the Vikings kind of put the clamps on them.
Well, the Purple People Eaters got to them, and in the second quarter, as you mentioned, they did do well the first quarter. They have not run the ball as well as they would like to have in the second quarter, and it's been all Minnesota ever since.
Well, we mentioned at the top of the show how important this game is for Minnesota. They can ill afford to lose here. In fact, if you look ahead to Minnesota, if they could afford to lose one game, it would be the game in Oakland. But in their division, against people like Detroit, who they have to play yet, and also this club from Green Bay, they just don't want to lose it.
They have a tougher schedule than what Chicago does the remainder of the year. And I know that they want to win this ball game. As you mentioned, if they're going to lose anything, they have to lose. They could lose to Oakland out there.
So that shows you how difficult this Central Division has become. I think the story has been the Vikings maybe are not playing badly. It's just the rest of the division starting to catch up a little bit.
They are. They have not drafted in a right in real good position. You know, they've always been last to draft every year, where the other teams have been one, two, three draft, been able to draft one or two and three, and these teams do keep will catch up if they continue to draft that way. The Minnesota's, of course, have been a bad drafting situation for the last 5 or 6 years.
And a guy by the name of Walter Payton is kind of shaking up football, isn't he? He's really something. All right, there you look at snowy Green Bay, Wisconsin. And the fans, I tell you, none of them have left. And they've got all kinds of garb on here. They're enjoying this, I believe. Look at them out there. Well, they got to move around a little bit, though. You might get snowed in.
It's been the first snowfall in Green Bay, and when they say it snows in Green Bay, they weren't kidding. This may just stay here until next April.
We may just keep you up here for a while.
Oh, my gracious.
All right, ready to go now. Second half of play. 13-6, Minnesota with the lead. Chester Markle, who missed a very important point after when the Packers scored first at the 7-18 mark of the first quarter. Manfred Moore is the deep man for Minnesota as it continues to snow. It hasn't let up all day long. Markle hits a pretty good one. Manfred Moore falls down at the 10 to the 15. He's coming out all the way to the 30, to the 35-yard line. Manfred Moore averting disaster back there. Andre Thompson eventually making the tackle on him. So again, you can see how treacherous the footing is. During the halftime intermission, they had some brooms out here, and you can see the paths of those brooms as they've tried as best they can to wipe off each yard line. But I tell you, as this game wears on, I think they're going to disappear just as fast. 13-6, the ball now at the 35-yard line. Minnesota with the lead again. They have Tucker and Boyd in the lineup, two tight ends. This is Brent McClanahan, and McClanahan across the 40 to the 42-yard line. McClanahan protecting that ball. His fumble in the first quarter set up the only Packer touchdown. Willie Buchanan making the tackle for Green Bay. And so it's going to bring up second down and 3 yards to go. Pickup of 7. McClanahan 23 yards for the afternoon. Foreman with 80. Here's Lee giving off to Chuck Foreman. And Foreman not going to get that first down. It's going to bring up a third down. It's interesting the strategy the Vikings are using. They're lining Tucker up right outside that outside hip of the other tight end, Stu Boyd.
Tucker's coming down and double-teaming on the defensive end, giving the hole, making the hole to the outside for McClanahan and Foreman. If Foreman is running, then McClanahan is picking up on anything that comes up to the outside. Foreman just running off of his block.
Third down, a short yard to go now. The ball at the 43-yard line. Steve Craig has checked in there. One tight end and diving forward, trying to get it is Foreman. Did he get it? Very, very close. He doesn't have to get out to the 45. He just has to be just short of it, and I believe he's got the first down from our vantage point. He did. First down, Minnesota. So the Vikings starting out on the initial series here of quarter number three. They came in here 6-4. They've lost three of their last six games, losing a tough one last week to the Chicago Bears 10-7. And Walter Payton, what a day he had, 275 yards. First down at the 45-yard line. Lee gives off to McClanahan, and McClanahan drags tacklers with him, close to a 5-yard pickup before Dave Purifoy and also Dave Roller combining on the tackle. McClanahan picking up some good yardage. You see the offensive lineman doing a good job now on the Green Bay Packer defense. Dave Purifoy, number 75, and Dave Roller making the tackle. They continue to run off that right-hand side. As John mentioned at halftime, they've been going at Tom Toner and Mike Butler. Second down, 6. Lee gives off to Foreman. Foreman protecting the ball, but no running room. Chuck Foreman at the midfield stripe. Shoved back by Fred Carr and Jimmy Carter. You can see Foreman wrapping both arms around that football. Ball now at the midfield stripe. Going to bring up third down. Still 5 yards to go for the Vikings. Stu Voigt comes out or check that. McClanahan checks out of the lineup. They've been using Sammy Johnson a lot at fullback. He was very effective in the first half of play. They have Robert Miller in this time. Rashad comes to the bottom of the screen. Again, the two tight ends. Third and 5. Lee gives off to Foreman, and he's not going to get the first down. Dave Roller again. I tell you, Dave Roller has quite a fan here, fan club, and they are roaring their approval of number 74.
Dave Roller has been having a good ball game out there this afternoon. He's been making tackles all over the field, making some fine plays, along with Purifoy. And, of course, Toner and the linebackers have been doing quite a bit of the tackling as well.
Fourth down, 5. Claybo to kick. Back deep, Johnny Gray. Here's the kick by Claybo. Johnny Gray calling for the fair catch, and he just kind of cradles that ball as he has it out at the 17-yard line. So Green Bay has the football for the first time in the second half of play. The Vikings with a 13-6 lead.
Wherever you may roam, you'll find our name is known.
You can trust at Delco.
Thanks, Delco.
Delco Freedom Battery.
When things are getting thick and you want to start real quick,
you can trust at Delco.
Thanks, Delco.
Delco Freedom Battery.
They've got the stuff when the starting's tough.
You can trust at Delco.
Thanks, Delco.
Delco Freedom Battery. Delco Freedom
Thanks, Delco.
This is combat in the field and in your home. New Telstar Combat, the video tank game with two-fisted controls found in real tanks so you can maneuver all over the battlefield. Dodge mines, one mistake and... Reload, aim, fire. The score mounts, the battle quickens, turn, fire. Telstar Combat gives you 4 different battle games. So hit your TV to a Telstar. Telstar Combat by Coleco.
The Packers have the ball to 17-yard line. Mark Mullaney, number 77, playing right defensive end in place of Jim Marshall. You can see where they're kind of shoveling the snow out, trying to get some good footing during that timeout. Whitehurst at quarterback for the Packers. Whitehurst giving off. And Eric Torkelson trying to find some running room. He may have gotten close to the 20-yard line. Jump back. Matt Blair over there and Alan Page. Blair's been all over the football field. There's Eric. They've used him a lot today. His ability to hang on to the football. A very reliable performer for Green Bay. 11th round draft pick in 1974. Second down, 7. A pickup of 3. Odom and Ollie Smith go to the top of the screen, flanked out, and you can see the snow. Just hasn't let up at all. From the 20-yard line. Whitehurst giving off to Torkelson again. And Eric Torkelson stays on his feet and gets a couple of yards. Eric Torkelson advancing the ball out to the 27-yard line, where it's going to bring up third down. Still a long 3 yards to go. Sutherland and McNeil over to make the tackle. Green Bay had the lead early in this game, 6-0. Then trailed 10-6 and now 13-6. Cox with 2 field goals. The other points coming on a 40-yard touchdown pass from Bob Lee to Sammy White. Look at him. John, there's just nobody leaving this ballpark.
And the snow's not letting up either, Gary.
Third down, a long three to go. White to throw. Far side, it's caught. Ollie Smith has got it. Ollie Smith has got it, and he's got a first down, just about a yard past that forward stick. First down, Green Bay. Whiter's had a lot of time to throw the football.
Plenty of time as the footing gets worse down on the field. More treacherous every minute with the snow continuing to come down. Excellent protection given Whitehurst. As he goes back and looks for his receiver, no one's open, and finally gets it over to Ollie Smith. He puts some stuff on that ball to get it all the way over there.
John, you've been impressed with the arm of Whitehurst, and there was a good example of it. First down now. Whitehurst on a delay to Torkelson. Torkelson right outside. Eric Torkelson fights his way loose. He's fighting his way up to the midfield stripe. What a run by Eric Torkelson. Jeff Wright got him. First down, Green Bay.
Excellent blocking by the Packers up front as Torkelson takes the ball on a draw. Breaks tackle after tackle. Seaman missed it. You see him a good break, a good hard running, and some good leg drive. As Torkelson moves the ball out, Jeff Wright, 23, finally brings him down. It's a 21-yard run by Eric Torkelson.
And it sets the ball up at the Packer 49-yard line. Hardy Smith and Willard Harrell are in the lineup. Torkelson getting a breather. Here's Barty Smith, and Barty bangs his way forward. He's into the Minnesota, into the field, to the 47-yard line. Doug Sutherland had quite a collision there with him. It's interesting to me how a guy like Torkelson, I guess with a wide base, he has the ability to run. He keeps those legs spread wide when he runs out there.
Very good balance and good strong leg drive is the answer to there, Gary.
Look at the snowmobile outfits, the feet. Oh, boy, it makes me cold to look at it. Second down, six, pick up a four at the 47 of Minnesota. Give to Will Harrell. Harrell trying to turn the corner, falls down, and he's going to get to the 45-yard line of Minnesota. Fred McNeil over there. And so we come to a third down and close to 5 yards to go. Willard Harrell, not a big guy. Bart Starr told us that he can play well in spot situations, but it's tough to play all the time. He takes such a beating. Weighs in at 182 pounds. Tell you, weigh a little more today if you stand out there very long. Soak up that jersey. Bert Askson now has come into the tight end for Green Bay. Jeff Seaman checks out for Minnesota. As we come to a third down and five. Whitehurst on a give to Harrell. Harrell is fighting for the first down. He's got it. Willard Harrell, that's the play that Minnesota's run so effectively. Off the right-hand side, the Packers are the first down.
Good blocking on that play as Harrell takes it off the right side. Big hole. Matt Blair, 59, finally brings him down, and that's a big first down for the Packers. Dick Himes, number 72, one of the initial blockers on that play.
Remember now, Green Bay started this drive from their own 17-yard line. They now have it at the 40-yard line, just inside the 40, the Viking end of the field. Whitehurst play action. Got time to throw. Throwing. Askson. He got it. Bert Askson at the five. That is only his second catch of the year. Bert Askson with his second catch. Paul Krause, Bobby Bryant's back. And he almost didn't get it, John. He bobbled it, but he hung on.
That ball was thrown perfectly by David Whitehurst. As you see, the coverage downfield by Krause and Wright. The ball was thrown right between them. Paul Krause, Bobby Bryant, Axton comes up with a catch, and it's first and 10 for the Packers.
He had one catch for 17 yards prior to that one. What a big one that one is. First and goal inside the five. McGeorge and Aston, two tight ends are in for the Packers. The Packers now trailing 13-6. Whitehurst rolling. He scored on this earlier, but he's not going anywhere this time. He scored from 3 yards out earlier on that play, but this time Alan Page, the veteran he is, was not fooled at all.
And the footing is bad down there, Gary, as David comes rolling out here to his left side. There's no way that he can plant and get back up inside like you'd want to. The footing is getting worse, but it's bad for both teams.
John, I'm really impressed with the job the quarterbacks have done passing. Earlier, we had a 40-yard touchdown pass from Lee to White, and now that was a 35-yard pass from Whitehurst to Aston. And now Odom comes in. McGeorge checks out. Aston stays in a tight end. It's going to be second and goal at the 7. A loss on that play, and now Whitehurst wants a timeout. Dave Whitehurst uses the Packers' first timeout of this second half with 6 minutes remaining in the third quarter. And here comes the young man, the eighth-round draft pick from Furman, who Bart Starr, you just hit it on the head, John, earlier in this telecast. You said he just kind of lights up when he talks about this young man.
Well, he sees the potential that Whitehurst has, and if anyone can teach him the intricacies of the game, that Bart can.
Let's look ahead to the CBS Sports Spectacular. Next Saturday at 5 o'clock Eastern, we're going to have the International Record Makers Tournament of Weightlifting from Las Vegas. A dozen world record weightlifters. Elise Alex Eve is going to be there, along with also Bruce Wilhelm and Tom Stock of St. Louis, as we're going to have a lot of countries involved in that one, John.
Oh, some of the countries will be Iran, Cuba, West Germany, Japan, Bulgaria, and last but not least, Hungary.
So that's next Saturday at 5 Eastern Time on the International Record Makers Tournament of Weightlifting. And that World's Strongest Man fits right into this category. That will also be televised next Saturday, the 9th event, and I can't get over this one. This is even tops last week's, the refrigerator race, 400-pound refrigerator, 40 yards. Can you imagine that?
I guess that's all right if you like refrigerators.
We have a score I want to pass along, a final. Atlanta defeated Tampa Bay 17-0, and John McKay still looking for a win at Tampa Bay. There is Bob Lee and Bud Grant discussing the situation. We have a second and goal at the 7-yard line. Artie Smith, Eric Torkelson, the running backs behind Whiter. Whiter. Ollie Smith, broken up by Jeff Wright at the 5. Tell you, that's the kind of pass that you got to be very careful with, John.
Jeff Wright was right there. It almost looked like he could have intercepted that ball, but Whitehurst had some speed on it. There was, he had the man covered all the way. No one was really open.
40, Harrell checks in, replacing Eric Torkelson. You know, earlier this year, the Packers were driving, threw an interception, and Houston picked it off. But a very similar play. The pass was deflected and went 95 yards. Zeke Moore. Third down, 7. Whitehurst again, got protection. Throwing, Ollie Smith intercepted. Bobby Bryant. Ollie Smith looked like he was open. Bobby Bryant stepped in and picked it off, and that's his fourth interception of the year. Big play for Minnesota.
Ollie Smith coming across the middle, looked like he was open. And that's all David saw. He didn't see the halfback drop that back in a Whitehurst. Had him open, but the Bryant dropped back off, made the interception. And now it's first and 10 for Minnesota on the 20-yard line.
Inside this new Firestone radial tire is an improved steel cord with 5 million miles of developmental testing. Where once we used 5 strands, we now use 10 strands of steel. 7 around 2, wrapped by 1. A cord construction so important, Firestone named the tire for it. 7-2-1. The new steel-belted Radial 721. Now, from Firestone.
Are you still chained to? Gotcha. The rechargeable Norelco Rotary Razor lets you walk away, free from nicks and cuts. Its 36 surgical steel rotary razor blades are safely protected inside 3 floating heads to give you a comfortable shave that's razor close, razor smooth, for up to 3 weeks on a single charge. The rechargeable Norelco Rotary Razor. It lets you walk away from. Gotcha.
An all-star cast in swashbuckling adventure in The Four Musketeers. A television premiere on the CBS Friday Night Movies at 9, 8 Central and Mountain Time.
Now, chestnuts roasting on an open fire. How about that, Jared?
John Unitas now appearing nightly. From the 20-yard line, first down now to that interception by Bobby Bryant. Here's Brent McClanahan. A big interception by Bobby Bryant, his fourth of the year. Stops a Packer drive on a third and seven. Dave Roller making the tackle. Pick up on the play of 3 yards. It'll be second and seven. Foreman and McClanahan, a good 1-2 punch in this game. Foreman with 84 yards, McClanahan with 30. The Packers now trying to hold after, I'm sure, that very disappointing turnaround of events on a pass that looked like it might be headed for a touchdown, but Bryant was in there for the interception. Bobby Lee off to McClanahan, and McClanahan just kind of disappears from sight, advances the ball out to the 28-yard line, which is going to bring up third down, 2 yards to go. Mike Butler making the stop. Got a lot of tackling people standing up, but, you know, you're just trying to keep your footing out there.
Footing just continues to get worse as the snow continues to come down.
I'll tell you, they said 6 inches. I think we've got that right now. 4:45 to go, third quarter. Second down, make that third down, 2 yards to go. Rashad to the bottom of the screen. Lee to McClanahan, he's got the first down. Brent McClanahan moves that ball all the way out across the 30 to the 35-yard line. Steve Luke eventually making the stop. The Packers had had that drive starting at the 17-yard line, eventually being stymied in the end zone. A very impressive drive in weather like today. Here's the final. Los Angeles defeated the Cleveland Browns 9-0. That's a big win for L.A. and a costly loss for Cleveland. First down. Bob Lee to throw on first down. He's in trouble. And Mike Butler got him. Somebody got the official. Mike Butler back there. That's now 6.5 sacks for that number one draft pick from Kansas.
Mike Butler beat Ron Yeri on his pass protection. I believe Yeri slipped on the field down there. Butler was able to get back to get Ron Lee. That's the first sack, I believe, for the Packers this afternoon.
Second down, 13, a loss. Back to the 30-yard line. Sammy White to the bottom of the screen. Rashad to the top. And a give and a little problem with that exchange. Looked like McClanahan and Lee almost collided in the backfield, and McClanahan went nowhere. And we come to a third down. I tell you, John, your timing, your footing, just a handoff is a chore out there right now.
And the defense reacts a little slower, Gary, on a field like this because they don't want to overcommit themselves. If they do and they mess up, someone makes a good block, and it's Katie Barr the door.
Ezra Johnson comes in now, replacing Bob Barber, right defensive end. Third down, almost 13 yards to go. Bob Lee gives off to McClanahan, and McClanahan not going to go very far. He got back to the original line of scrimmage. And so now Minnesota's going to kick the football as Steve Luke, number 46, fired up on that play.
Steve came up and made a real fine play on it. Number 46 in on the tackle. There he is. Good tackle by Steve Luke.
Art Starr told us that Steve Luke really worked hard in the offseason to strengthen himself, and he's played much better football this year. So now it is fourth down and 10 yards to go. Claybo to kick. Johnny Gray is deep for Green Bay. Claybo in this game, putting the ball very well. He hits one end over end. Johnny Gray's going to let it hit because down there in a hurry, the Minnesota Vikings, and I mean in a hurry, is getting down on that play was Joe Blaha, the former Nebraska standout. So the Packers have the football again with 2:02 to go, third quarter. Minnesota 13, Green Bay 6.
Stop sitting around, Mom. Let's take a ride in my new Ford pickup.
All right, let me drive. Hope I can handle it.
This is the one that's built tough with Ford's exclusive twin I-beam suspension and a new four-speed overdrive option.
Fire up.
And extensive rust-fighting materials on underbody parts.
What do you think, Mom?
You may think I'm off my rocker. This Ford is tough.
Of all Ford trucks registered over the last 12 years, 93 out of 100 are still on the job.
I dare you to knock this off.
I dare you to compare anybody's batteries, anybody's, with alkaline power cells. Try to beat them for long life. You know what? You can't. When you want long-lasting energy, you can't buy a longer-lasting, all-purpose power system than gold, red, and black alkaline power cells from EverReady. Come on. I dare you.
13-6 our score here. Hey, you want to relive Johnny Cash's all-time favorite Christmases? As Johnny gathers his family and friends, Roy Clark, Jerry Lee Lewis, Roy Orbison, Carl Perkins, and the Statler Brothers for a delightful Christmas special Wednesday at 10, 9 Central in Mountain Time, right here on CBS. The Packers have the ball after a 31-yard kick on their own 35-yard line. First down, they trail 13-6. Torkelson and Smith, the running back. This is Torkelson. And Torkelson's going to lose some yardage. That play just didn't get developed. Carl Eller coming back to make the stop. Got some finals again. Cincinnati defeating the New York Giants 30-13. Boy, here's a tough one, John. Pittsburgh leading the Jets by 3 in the fourth quarter, 23-20.
Mike Todd must be back for the New York Jets.
And now New England leading Philadelphia in the fourth quarter, 14-6. I'll tell you, those Eagles are the best 3-7 football team maybe in the NFL.
They really play fine defense in Philadelphia.
Second down, they say it's 10. No loss on that last play and no gain. Whitehurst with a minute 20 to go in the third quarter, throwing under pressure, and it is intercepted. Picked off by Paul Krause. And Krause now is one interception short of the record by Tunnell. There's a flag, however, on the play. It was deflected further up the field by McNeil. And then Paul Krause coming up to pick it off. And Paul Krause, now for his career, has 78 interceptions, and he's one behind M. Tunnell. And so the Vikings have the football with a minute 12 to go in this third quarter, and they have a 13-6 lead.
Stuntman, you get the bruises instead of the glory. You hit the deck and bite the dust till your bones ache. But now comes Miller time. Time to reach for the best tasting beer you can find. Miller High Life, America's quality beer.
If you've got the time, we've got the beer.
Miller Beer.
Announcing a unique new motor oil from Exxon Research that can actually save money. New Golden Natural Uniflow. Uniflow was tested in cars like yours. After break-in, it delivered an overall average of 16 extra miles per tank full. Savings like that could cut your gasoline bill the equivalent of about 3 cents a gallon. New Uniflow motor oil is Exxon's best engine protection ever. It conserves gasoline, saves money.
Just a moment ago, Paul Krause with his 78th interception of his career.
See Whitehurst throwing the football. It's tipped right there, and that's something that the Vikings do very, very well. The linebackers drop back into a real fine drop and knock the ball around. You saw the clip on the play after Krause had made the interception.
It was Jeff Wright with the clip, so it moves the ball back to the 34-yard line of Minnesota, and here comes Chuck Foreman, but not for very far. Well, Paul Krause with an interception, Bobby Bryant with an interception, both of them coming here in this third quarter, one of them in the end zone. As Green Bay has been putting the pressure on Minnesota, but thus far haven't been able to do anything on the scoreboard. They trail 13-6, and that was our halftime score. Second down, 5. A pickup of 5 for Foreman, and Foreman is approaching 100 yards for the day. Ahmad Rashad, along with Sammy White, go flank to the top of the screen. Foreman with 88 yards for the day. Bob Lee to Foreman. And Foreman gets the ball out to about the 40-yard line, to the 41, where it's going to bring up third down and 3 yards to go. Tom Toner, Dave Purifoy combining on the stop. Minnesota hasn't gotten anything going really in this third quarter offensively. Well, I tell you though, they put it together in that second quarter of play. 40-yard touchdown pass and 2 field goals by Fred Cox as we're winding down now, the end of the third quarter of play. Minnesota now 15 minutes away from trying to stay ahead of the Chicago Bears. That's the end of the third quarter with the score Minnesota 13, Green Bay 6. We now pause for a word from your local station.
A radical group of vigilantes gets a new recruit, a somewhat naive Archie Bunker, tonight at 8, 7 Central and Mountain on CBS.
Fun at the old ballpark here in Lambeau Field. Everybody having a good time. I'll tell you, she's going to get her hair very wet before the afternoon is over. We start the fourth quarter. Third down and two for Minnesota. Miller in the backfield along with Foreman. And here comes Robert Miller. And did he get the first down? He fought for it. On a third and two, he's going to be very, very close. Bob Barber, the initial hit for Green Bay. We've just started the fourth quarter. 13-6, Minnesota with the lead. Trying to get an important first down, and they're unpiling. Let's see, they may have to measure. And that's what they're going to do. They're going to bring the sticks in, an important measurement here as we start the fourth quarter. There's Fred Carr. He's trying to help him out a little bit there.
The Packer defense has been tough the third quarter. You see Fred Carr, and there's someone else is measuring. Dave Roller,
right.
He's up. He's saying it's very, very short.
So they aren't even going to measure. Carr told them where it was. Fourth down.
Don't you wish you could do that all the time, huh?
Boy, I tell you, I quit trying to guess on those. It's interesting. Every time somebody goes back for a punt, they got to look out for the guys with the brooms because they come off the field trying his every opportunity to sweep the field off. Johnny Gray, that's Gray. Number 24 is back. Neil Clavo to kick. Beautiful kick by Clavo. Johnny Gray back at the 20. And Gray's not going to go anywhere. Boy, it's tough to turn up field.
Not much you can do when the footing is bad as it is.
39-yard kick. Flaha down for the stop. John, let's look ahead now to some New Year Day activity. The Fiesta Bowl on Sunday, December 25th, right here on CBS. Penn State against Arizona State. What Penn State won a game in similar weather conditions yesterday.
They threw the ball well yesterday. As did Pitt, but Penn State came up with a win.
They're 10-1 for the year in the Sun Bowl from El Paso, December 31st, Stanford, LSU, and then the Cotton Bowl. What a game that's going to be. Texas versus Notre Dame right here on CBS. Torkelson, Barty Smith, the running backs at the 21-yard line. Eric Torkelson, and he's not going to go anywhere. Very fine reaction that time. Doug Sutherland and Alan Page. And they're going to be thrown for a loss back inside the 19. You know, that Cotton Bowl game between Texas and Notre Dame will be January 2nd, a Monday. Boy, Texas and Earl Campbell, he had 222 yards and had 57-28 win over Texas A&M.
And I wonder who the people of Green Bay will be rooting for, don't you, Gary?
Boy, it'll be some game from the 19-yard line. I'm not going to touch that one. Second down, 12. There's a delay to Torkelson. Torkelson, they try to strip the ball from him, but he hangs on. Comes across the 20 to the 23-yard line. Alan Page making the tackle. Alan Page, the MVP in the NFL in 1971. Pro Bowl eight straight years. 6'4". They say he weighs about 230, maybe even less than that this year. 20 sacks last year. He is something.
Mark Mullaney can get a great deal of work the second half, plays with Jim Marshall.
Mullaney, heir apparent in that position. Number one draft pick in 75 out of Colorado State. Third down, 6, Whitehurst. And he is hit hard from behind. He is hit very hard. Dick Himes pounced on the ball, but Alan Page unloaded on him. Boy, was he hit on this play. That's Dave Roller. He's played quite a game for Green Bay.
Roller been in on a number of tackles. There's also pretty good head linesman out there. Be able to tell you whether the ball is short or long for the first down.
He played in the Canadian Football League, the World Football League, acquired in the middle of the 75 season after playing for the Southern California Sun. And now Beverly will kick inside his own 5-yard line. Manfred Moore deep for the Vikings. 12-24 remaining in the game. Beverly continues to kick the ball very well. Manfred Moore all the way back and hit immediately.
Great reaction that time. Andre Thompson, number 43. He came storming down the field. There'll be no return on that one. Minnesota continues to lead Green Bay 13-6, 12-13 to go.
Sir.
It's about time you're here. Another late night, I presume? Well, let's get started. The first thing we have for your assignment is this microcassette tape recorder.
Genius. Did you design this, sir?
No. Actually, it's a Sony. Next is this radio with 32 worldwide bands. Can tune in just about any place.
Extraordinary. Who gets the credit for this one?
This is a Sony, too. You'll also need this ultra-compact portable video camera, and we're going to mount this 5-inch color TV in your car, along with this Betamax deck for playback.
Remarkable. Are they,
Yes. They're Sony also.
Excuse me, sir, but did you just walk into a store and buy these?
Well, yes.
Well, keep up the good work, sir.
If it's a little extraordinary, chances are it's a Sony.
On January 2nd, CBS Sports presents the Cotton Bowl with the number one ranked Texas Longhorns taking on the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame. That's the Cotton Bowl, January 2nd.
The guy with the earphones on is Bill Curry, a former teammate of yours, John, the offensive line coach, and he's doing quite a job with this young offensive line.
Took a lot of snaps from Billy Curry, and he's not too happy about that last play where his offensive men let the Vikings get to the quarterback.
First down 10 now for the 42. Minnesota with the ball, and Brent McClanahan. McClanahan picking up 5 yards on the play. Minnesota has hung on to this 13-6 lead. You know, in a game like this, you have a lead. You're a little reluctant to start opening up too much. Purifoy, Roller combining on the stop. There's 38. Bob Tucker out of Bloomsburg State. He's a little All-American there. He led the NFL in receiving in 1971 with 59 catches. Gain of 4, 2nd and 6. Chuck Foreman. Foreman slanting forward. He's going to ring up 3rd down and along 3 yards to go. Chuck Foreman now 92 yards for the afternoon. That was Purifoy again on the tackle. So Green Bay now trying to get the football back on a 3rd down, 3 yards to go. The ball at the 49-yard line of Minnesota. Houston leading Kansas City, 3rd quarter, 20-6. Bob Lee's in trouble. And a great tackle. A head tackle by Johnny Gray separates the ball on the far sideline. Tom Toner put the pressure on that play. And I believe Lee threw the ball before he wanted to.
Bobby Lee faking to Chuck Foreman, throws the ball out. Watch the tackle by Gray. He strips the ball. Johnny Gray, 24, strips the ball from the receiver. And Minnesota has to kick.
On 4th and 3, and the Packer defense continues to sparkle in the second half. Johnny Gray is back. Claybo kicking for the 7th time. He's averaging 37 yards for the day. He hit this one. Gray did not call for the fair catch, and he's going to be down to the 12-yard line. Brett McNeil getting down there for Minnesota. So the Packers a long ways away at their own 12-yard line after a 41-yard kick by Neil Claybo.
Here in Chicago, we're evaluating the world's first light wave communication system, carrying our customers' voice, data, and video. A half-inch cable like this can contain enough glass fibers to carry as many phone calls as 6 of those copper cables. Besides increasing capacity, someday this system will help keep costs down. We've taken light wave communications out of the labs. We've put it under the streets, and it's working.
Bell System Technology, keeping your phone system the best in the world.
Ford introduces Futura, a dramatic combination of styling and technology for 1978 and beyond. Futura, designed by computer modeling and aerodynamic testing. It can provide excellent fuel economy and room for 5 passengers as well. Futura, designed for 1978 and beyond. Realistically priced for today. See your Ford dealer for a personal test drive.
Zeke Bratkowski looking on. The crowd chanting, go Pack, go. John, I got a question for you. How did a tiny country like East Germany run away with 40 Olympic gold medals? That's one of the stories tonight on 60 Minutes.
Oh, well, good. I'm going to watch that.
You're going to be snowed in somewhere. You're going to have to. First down now. The ball at the 12-yard line. The Packers trail 13-6. Whiter's going to throw on first down. Got nice protection. Throwing. Ollie Smith almost intercepted by Nate Wright. Nate Wright waiting on that one. Almost came up with it. That's twice now. Ollie Smith has been the intended target. One time intercepted and a near miss.
Well, Ollie slipped down that time, Gary. That's what I mentioned to you before, that the offensive receiver must be careful of making his breaks on a field like this. He slipped down and the ball hit Nate Wright right in the chest, and he really did not expect it.
And it's tough to catch a ball today. Second down, 10 from the 12. 10:44 left in this one. Whitehurst wasting no time. Going to throw again. This is Ollie Smith. And he's got it this time. And, John, I believe that's the same play.
He came back to him on the same type of a play. This time, Ollie Smith would continue back to the inside. Beat Nate Wright this time on it. Ollie Smith came up with a fine reception. David Whitehurst put the ball right on the money. As we see, coming right back to him. Fine reception. Ball crossed number 22, and Nate Wright finally making the tackle in his first and 10 for the Green Bay Packers.
22-yard pass completion to Ollie Smith. Whiter 6 of 16 for the afternoon. The ball at the 35-yard line. Whiter to Eric Torkelson. Torkelson going outside for about three. A lot of congestion. Torkelson pick up a three. It'll bring up second down and seven. Well, Whitehurst has the arm, John. There's just no question he has a major league arm.
He has good speed on the ball both times that he threw it. He's learning. He's picked a little bump every day, and he's going to have to continue to learn if he's going to improve, that's for sure. And Bart Starr is very satisfied with this young man to this point.
Second down, seven. Odom, Ollie Smith to the top of the screen. A give to Barty Smith, and Smith is to the 40-yard line and across it to the 41. John, this reminder on many of these same CBS stations, the CBS doubleheaders, we're going to have Dallas at Washington, a very crucial game, that NFC Eastern Division.
And Washington always gives Dallas a fit, regardless where they play in Dallas or Washington. Could be a real good ball game, and we may even get to see Mr. Whiskey Kilmer in that ball game.
Is that a prediction?
I hope so. I like you better.
Third down now. And still 3 yards to go for Green Bay at their own 42-yard line. Odom, Ollie Smith again. Flank to the top of the screen. Aston, the tight end. Whitehurst trying to option. Pitches out to Torkelson. And I believe, did he get it? Did he get the first down? No, I don't believe he did. They're marking where he hit, and I don't think he got it, John.
It's going to be very, very close. I believe they're going, well, the official down on the sidelines is marking fourth down.
That's right. His knee touched. And that's where they're marking it. His body had fallen forward, but his knee had touched on the field just in front of that stick. So it's fourth down.
Big decision coming up here now. What do you do?
Well, that's the old college option. We knew they'd put that in because of Whitehurst's running ability, and he ran it at Furman.
Richford George coming into the ball game with two tight ends in the ball game for blocking purposes.
Well, here we come to a big play at the 8:17 mark. Fourth, less than a yard to go. The ball just needs to get to that 45-yard line. It's just short of it. Whitehurst gives to Barty Smith. He got it. And this crowd, a muffled applause with their gloved hands, up and cheering as the Packers continue to relentlessly try to tie this game up. They've been battling the entire second half to get on the scoreboard.
Barty Smith looked like a high jumper on this play, up and over the top, but picked up the first down, and a crucial first down for Green Bay as there's only 7:36 left in this ball game, and they are behind 13-6.
At the 47, a first down. Odom, Ollie Smith to the bottom of the screen. Whitehurst play action fake. Look out. Throwing Ollie Smith. He did not see it. Alan Page dumped Whitehurst, or that
pass might have been completed. He released it before Smith had made his move. Whiter's getting up, kind of holding his right arm. Alan Page has hit him twice with a ton of bricks.
And Ollie Smith, his man fell down back there. Had he been able to look around quickly enough, he may have had that reception and continue still running downfield.
Whitehurst has thrown a scare into the Vikings. He's come out throwing here in this fourth quarter. He's now 6 of 17 for 76 yards. Again, he brings Smith and Odom to the near side. Second and 10. Whitehurst back. Protection's there this time. And falling down is Ollie Smith again. And Nate Wright, that's a replay. Check that. That's Odom that fell down. But that's a replay of Nate Wright earlier, who had a chance for the interception. It's just tough to hang on to that football.
Again, I believe he was surprised on that ball coming straight in as Odom slipped on the slippery turf, as we see. Right there, you see him going down and the ball hitting Nate Wright right in the head, right in the chest. Of course, Nate Wright being surprised twice, you just don't expect it to come.
Third down now, 10. San Diego leading Seattle out on the King Dome. 7-0, first quarter. Smith, Will Harrell, the running backs on a third down 10 for the 47-yard line. Whitehurst again. Protection is there. Throwing deep. Odom is down here. He goes up with Nate Wright. Very well defended that time by Nate Wright. Wright with two interceptions, one of them last week. Had seven interceptions last year, a career high. And there's Steve Odom. So fourth down, the Packers are going to have to punt. 7:05 still, time remaining. 13-6, Minnesota with the lead. A touchdown, two field goals. The Packers scored on a touchdown but missed the point after. Everly to kick. Manfred Moore is deep now. He's standing back at the 15-yard line of Minnesota. Everly kicking away from him to the far side, and that ball is going to hit just outside the 20. Let's see where they're going to mark it. Going to mark it at the 19-yard line. So Minnesota hasn't had much offense in the second half of play. Has the ball at their own 19-yard line. 6 minutes, 58 seconds to go. They have the lead.
Just listen to that. That's just one of the great original hits in this exclusive new Firestone Christmas album. This is a really big collection of all-time favorite Christmas classics with many of the artists who made them famous. It's yours for only $1.69. 8-track tape, $1.99. At Firestone stores and dealers just about everywhere. Merry Christmas, everybody.
You work in the sky, with nothing to hold on to but the wind and the cold steel beam. And it's a very long day until a whistle blows telling you it's Miller time. Time for the best tasting beer you can find. Miller High Life, America's quality beer since 1855.
Look at the time, we've got the beer.
I think we're fast becoming snowbound here in Green Bay. They're now giving weather reports here in the Green Bay area, saying that what road conditions have really deteriorated. It's been snowing since 8 o'clock this morning. And now from the 19-yard line, Minnesota with the ball. First down. Bob Lee giving off to Robert Miller. Dave Roller's there. Boy, you know he's there because his arms are uplifted the minute he makes a play.
Dave Roller has a great fan club here. As you can see, this whole stands are up hollering, Roller, Roller, Roller. He's been all over the field all afternoon. Take a look at him right there.
So Green Bay, who just relentlessly tried somehow to pull into a tie, playing good defense. Loss of two, second and 12. The ball at the 17 of Minnesota. 6.5 minutes to go in this game. Bob Lee gives to Foreman, who almost fell down. And Foreman somehow converts it into yardage. What a resourceful runner he is. Fred Carr hammered him down. But Chuck Foreman, he just does it all. Third down, still going to be 8 yards to go. A couple of finals, John. Pittsburgh just got by the New York Jets 23-20. New England by the Eagles 14-6. The Eagles have played close with everyone, but they've only won 3 games this year.
Chuck Foreman having his biggest day against the Green Bay Packers.
23 attempts, 98 yards. Here we go. Third down, 9 for the 21. The crowd is yelling. Give to Foreman. He fumbled the ball and Grant Bass recovered. Dave Roller jumping with, let's see who's got it. Foreman has fumbled the ball. Look at Roller. Mike Butler, number 77, we think got it. Let's see.
Dave Roller right there on the tackle along with Butler, who makes the reception on the fumble, the pickup on the fumble, and that is another turnover for the Minnesota Vikings as they've lost 18 out of 24 fumbles this year.
18-yard line. Our spotter, Bob Brennan, doing an excellent job, and he's been taxed today trying to pick him up out there, but he fell on that one. Mike Butler with the fumble recovery from the 18. First down, Green Bay. Whiters gives off to Torkelson, and Torkelson fights his way inside the 15-yard line. Larry McCarron, Mel Jackson, Dick Hines throwing the key blocks ahead of Torkelson. The Packers, boy, they just haven't given up in the second half, John.
The defense has played extremely well the second half and have not really given the Minnesota Vikings too much yardage on the ground.
Second down, 5. A long 5. The ball at the 13-yard line. Whitehurst gives off to Torkelson again, and Torkelson's close to the 10-yard line. Eric Torkelson close to the 10, where it's going to come to a third down. Again, Jackson, McCarron throwing the blocks ahead of him. And Eric Torkelson has been a very reliable runner today. 53 yards on 14 carries. He's the leading ground gainer for Green Bay. Third down, 2. You can hear the go pack go. A victory star crowd here in Lambeau Field.
They don't seem to be fooled at all.
Third down, a long 2. Almost 3 yards to go. Outside the 10, at the 10 and a half. This is Marty Smith. Doesn't find a lot of running room. The ball may have been fumbled, was it? They're unpiling. Marty Smith getting up. They did. Minnesota recovered it. Marty Smith fumbled the ball inside the 10-yard line, and Minnesota has come up with a big fumble recovery. Getting up is Alan Page. He was right on the bottom of that. A big fumble recovery. So two interceptions and a fumble recovery. The Vikings have done very well. They've been very opportunistic here in this second half of play. The ball now at the 8-yard line. So after Foreman fumbled at the 18-yard line, the Packers, Marty Smith gives it back. Time, 4:04 remaining. Foreman and Miller, the running back. At the 8-yard line, a give. And Miller trying to get some running room. Comes out to the 10-yard line. The Packers now have 2 timeouts remaining in this game. Minnesota, all 3 of theirs remaining. Miller bringing the ball just outside the 10-yard line. Second down, 7. 3:44 and the clock ticking away. It's this crowd here surviving the weather and hoping somehow that their Packers could end a 5-game losing streak against Minnesota. The Vikings trying to hang on and stay ahead against Chicago, who's a half game out. Second and 7. Foreman trying to go wide. Willie Buchanan wrestling him down and out of bounds. Chuck Foreman just would not go down on that play. He's over or close to 100 yards. He lost some yardage earlier after having 98 going back to 95. They're going to mark the ball outside the 10 to the 13-yard line. Make it the 12 and a half. Third down now and still 5 yards to go. 3 minutes. The clock winding down. They're going to send Rashard to the bottom of the screen, flanked out. 2 tight ends. Boyd, Tucker in there. Third down, 5 yards to go. Bob Lee gives off to Foreman. Foreman, is he going to get the first down? It's going to be close. I don't believe he got it. He did not, and it brings up a fourth down. And so again, the defense of Green Bay has done the job.
They have to push up against their goal line. Clayton
Claybaugh's really going to have to hit this one. You probably have a pretty good punt rush this time, Garrett, with chances trying to take a chance of maybe blocking it or at least hurrying him up for a bad kick.
Steve Luke and Tom Toner, four-step play to stop Foreman short of the first down. Foreman now has 101 yards on 26 carries. Third 100-yard day of the year. Johnny Gray is back now. Neil Claybaugh with a big, big punt. And they're going to take a delay of game, John. They're not even going to take or even attempt a punt. They're going to run down those 30 seconds, and they have, well, wait a minute. We got the two-minute warning. So the two-minute warning is here. 2 minutes remaining. Minnesota leads Green Bay 13-6.
This realistic 40-channel CB radio is on sale right now at your nearby Radio Shack for the unbelievable low price of $49.95. That's 50% off our catalog price. And our realistic model 466 is ready to use on all 40 CB channels. For under $50, get the convenience and security of two-way CB communication today. The sale-priced realistic 40-channel CB radio, only at Radio Shack, a Tandy company.
How much should you expect from a great camera? Polaroid's SX70 lets you shoot automatically, very close, or very far away. In lots of light, or hardly any. Shoot every second and a half, and have beautiful pictures in minutes. No other camera in the world does it all. The SX70 Alpha 1.
Two minutes remaining in this game. The Minnesota Vikings going to have to punt the football. They have a fourth down, one. They lead 13-6. Their backs to the wall. And Johnny Gray goes back deep. This is Claybaugh standing inside the five-yard line. The crowd is on their feet. Claybaugh, very little pressure, gets away a wobbly kick. Coming up, Johnny Gray, and he makes the catch and doesn't fair catch it. Whew. That's twice he's done that today. Joe Blaha is down there instantly to down him. And so now the Packers with good field position. Nobody has left here. Of course, I'm not sure they can get anywhere right now because of the weather conditions. There's your time, a 34-yard kick. And the ball is now just across the midfield stripe. Minnesota into the field at the 49-yard line. 1:52 left. Smith and Harrell, the running backs for Green Bay. Whitehurst on first down. Throwing up the field, Odom. Odom had fallen down or he might have made the catch. And Whitehurst was dumped again, this time by Doug Sutherland. Sutherland unloaded on him back at the 40-yard line.
Fred McNeil was back there, but Fred had slipped too as Odom went to catch the ball. His feet went up from underneath him. It is very slippery out there, Garrett.
John, I'm impressed how well both teams have run their offense as far as the passing game is concerned under these conditions. Whitehurst now 6 of 20, 76 yards. Second down, 10 for the 49 of Minnesota. Now McCarron wants the ball wiped off. They're going to stop the action. Larry McCarron, a vastly improved football player. He hit the weights on the offseason, picked up some strength, and he's playing much better football. Second down, 10. Whitehurst again, protections there. Odom, Steve Odom, off his fingertips. Paul Krause coming over and making some contact. And it's third down, 10. 1:42, you see the time. There she is. I think she's a little numb right now, not saying an awful lot. Boy, you see such multicolored garb out here in Lambeau Field. These people are experts at keeping warm. Will Harrell now started out of the game. Now comes back in. Aston's coming out. They have a little problem now getting their offensive alignment. And they're going to have to use a timeout. So that only gives Green Bay one timeout remaining, with 1:42 left in the game. So Whitehurst is over on a very important third and 10. As you see Zeke Bratkowski in the gold warm-up, Bart Starr standing down there talking with their rookie from Furman. Looking ahead now, reminder, immediately following this game, we'll be switching on most of these CBS stations to the Dallas-Washington game from RFK Stadium. But looking ahead next week, The Chicago Bears, who are watching this one, I'm sure, with a great deal of interest, meet Tampa Bay. St. Louis against the Giants. That's always a good one. Washington against Buffalo, who plays Monday night against Miami. And then we have Detroit, Green Bay. Another black and blue division battle. Philadelphia, Dallas, San Francisco, and Minnesota. Interestingly enough, Detroit might come here with the same kind of weather conditions a week from today. You never know.
And it could be worse.
Our story here is third down 10 for the Packers with 1:42 remaining. They trail 13-6, and they have a chance to tie it up and go into overtime. They scored first in this game on a 3-yard touchdown run, missed the point after. Then the Vikings came back with a 40-yard touchdown pass, two field goals by Fred Cox, and that's where we are right now. Ollie Smith, Steve Odom, Bert Askson in, Will Harold, and Marty Smith, the running back. Whiter, good protection. And Will Harrell, the intended receiver, Matt Blair defending on the play. Harrell thought he was interfered with. Fourth down. Fourth down, 10, and John, I guess there's no tomorrow right now. You got to go for it with a minute 36.
That's right. You have nothing to lose at this point. See what Whitehurst comes up with. He looked to me like he had a man down the middle that time, but of course, Paul Krause is going to play as deep as the deepest man, and he'll let you get all the way down to the goal line before you get behind it.
This may be the play, the last chance the Packers have. Fourth and 10 from the 49. Whitehurst back again. Protection there. Throwing. Ollie Smith, he had it and dropped it. Ollie Smith had it and dropped it. And the Packers have run out of downs with 1:31 left. Good coverage again by Minnesota.
Whitehurst all had Ollie Smith coming down inside. Good protection. As you see the ball being thrown, Ollie Smith come up almost with a good catch. But a little bit too late.
So Minnesota now with 1:31. The Packers have only one timeout remaining. And good field position. The ball on their own 49-yard line. The Green Bay defense has done the job in the second half. Minnesota hanging on to that precarious lead. And now, falling on the ball is Bob Lee. Maybe lost a yard on the play, and the Packers going to use their timeout. With 1:25, Green Bay uses their last timeout. Well, the Minnesota Vikings, 6-4 coming into today's game. Winning today will go to 7-4. But tell you, there's a lot of football left to be played because they have San Francisco next week. Then they go to Oakland to beat the Raiders and then wind up their season in the Silver Dome against the Detroit Lions. Chicago plays Tampa, then Green Bay, and then the Giants. So Minnesota definitely has the tougher of the two schedules. The Vikings are going to hold that one-game lead if they hang on to this with a minute 25. The Packers, no timeouts remaining now. So the time will wind down. Third down coming up, 11 yards to go. Minnesota for the second consecutive week playing without Fran Tarkenton. Last week, Bob Lee did a creditable job under some bad weather conditions, hitting 12 of 24. Here today, he's 5 of 8 for 68 yards, and the big one, a 40-yard touchdown pass to Sammy White. Chuck Foreman at 101 yards under terrible field conditions. Third down, and they're just punching around, so it's going to be fourth down now. The Packers going to get a crack at the ball. They're going to get a last-ditch chance now. Thanks to our producer, Howard Reifschneider. I bet they're kind of cold down there in that truck. Our director, Marvin Mews. Two men who've had their work cut out today because of the weather conditions, but a good job, the pictures and the support they've given us, excellent. You see the time winding down now. They're gonna take the delay of game. Should happen with about 10 seconds to go, I believe. Well, I missed that one. There it is, with 3 seconds to go. I knew they're going to get a delay of game somewhere. So now delay a game, 5 yards, stops the clock with 3 seconds left. So on fourth down, you know they're not going to kick it. They're just going to fall on the ball. So they will not get any kind of a crack at the ball. You know that Minnesota will not kick it. As Chuck Foreman trots off the field, a job well done for him. 26 carries, 101 yards. Green Bay, their record will go to 2-9. Football team that battled very well Monday night against Washington and came right out here against Minnesota today and gave them all they wanted. Bob Lee going back. He's playing cat and mouse, and that's the game. So the Minnesota Vikings now have defeated the Green Bay Packers 13-6. A little conversation going on between Dave Roller and Bob Lee. I'll tell you, that Dave Roller, he likes to play the game of football. And Bud Grant, who earlier this year picked up his 100th win against these very same Green Bay Packers, has now directed his team to a 7-4 record. A must win for him today. It was a struggle for him, but I think this guy expected it, as his team, their backs to the wall, leading 13-6, held on to that lead in the second half with interceptions by Bobby Bryant and Paul Krause, and a fumble recovery on the 8-yard line and a fumble by Barty Smith as they hang on to win. So the Vikings now will get ready for San Francisco with that 7-4 record. And the Vikings have now won 6 in a row over the Green Bay Packers. They've won 9 of their last 11. And Bart Starr, who's in his third year as the coach of Green Bay, is still looking for his first win over the Minnesota Vikings. But again, you could see the Packers had some improvement. Their defense played remarkably well, particularly in the second half, as the big play now, 40-yard touchdown pass from Bob Lee to Sammy White. 13-6, the Minnesota Vikings over the Green Bay Packers. Stay tuned as the NFL Today continues after this word from your local station.
The monster that thrilled the nation is back, and he holds the fate of a beautiful girl in his hands. Don't miss the return of the Incredible Hulk tomorrow night on CBS.
Minnesota Vikings winning their 7th game of the year against 4 setbacks here this afternoon on a snow day. And I mean snow. We're going to have at least 6 inches before the day is over. The Vikings win it 13-6. They actually trailed early in this game. Dave Whitehurst, after a fumble recovery off of Brent McClanahan, taking it over on a bootleg on a 3-yard scamper. Then the point after was missed by Chester Markle, and that's the way the first quarter ended. But then the big play of the game was the 40-yard touchdown pass from Bob Lee to Sammy White. Well, it continues to snow. The fans file out here as the Green Bay Packers have lost a tough one, 13-6 to the Minnesota Vikings. As the Vikings, with their backs to the wall, keep a 1-game lead over the Chicago Bears in the Central Division of the NFC. They're now 7-4, and Chicago now having to wait for what they hope is another day to catch up with Minnesota. The Packers started out this game after a fumble recovery on the 21-yard line, marching it in on a 3-yard keeper by Dave Whitehurst. The point after was missed by Chester Markle. It ended 6-0 after one quarter of play. Then the big play of the game was Bob Lee with a 40-yard touchdown pass to Sammy White. The point after made it 7-6. That would have been enough to win, but then Fred Cox, who came in here today, kicked a 21-yard field goal and a 31-yard field goal. As an end result, he's now second on the all-time scoring list, moving ahead of the toe, Lou Groza, and now trails only George Blanda. In the second half, the Packers kept constant pressure on the Minnesota Vikings. They had a real opportunity to score in the third quarter, only to have Bobby Bryant pick off a pass intended for Ollie Smith in the end zone. The Packers relentlessly came right back. They had another opportunity, only to have Paul Kraus pick off an interception, which, by the way, is his 78th of the year. He's now only one short of the all-time record by M. Tunnell. And then the Packers had a fumble recovery at the 18-yard line off of Chuck Foreman. Then they marched in, only to fumble themselves on the 8-yard line. Barty Smith coughing up the football. For all intents and purposes, that was a real last legitimate crack that the Packers had at scoring. But it was a very fine performance by the Packers. Their record now 2-9 as they lose 13-6.